Hello, beautiful people. Welcome in, welcome in. Get your nails done, right? Paint and polish. That's all I hear every time I hear it. But welcome in, beautiful people. Sorry, I'm just pre-setting up my nails still. Because, you know, that's how we do it. Slow and steady wins the race. But welcome in, paint and polish. Hopefully you're having a fantastic Tuesday. I decided I want to try this out. We'll see how this goes. 2 5s. Hope everyone's having a fantastic Tuesday. For some reason, it feels like it's a Thursday to me, which I really wish it kind of was, because I'm ready for this week to be over. But, you know, that happens most weeks. Last week... Oh, the funny thing is, I swear it was like, what was it, yesterday? My husband's like, is today Tuesday? I'm like, buddy, it's only Monday. We just started this crazy week. But I did go see my doctor. My AC1 is up a little higher, but still in the manageable thing. She's not too concerned, which is okay. So I'm at a 6.1 right now. 6.5. It was 5.5, so oops, but, you know, I had to stop taking one medication, so that kind of explains what's going on there. It happens, you know, medication's expensive nowadays. Okay, so that's set up. I'm thinking about making this set for myself, but we might make it a little more Christmassy on the tree. And we might put a red dot on the nose for Rudolph. Make it more, even more Christmassy. That's an idea anyways. Okay, so I got that done. Okay, let me just get a sip of water. Because, you know, I have a nice small bottle of water here. This should hold for this stream, right? Okay, that's better. That's a whole lot better. Oh, as I shake the thing, gotta remember that one's a bit bigger. So I thought we'll start off by, I'm gonna put on this set, this one set I did for Christmassy, because I've had these on for 3 weeks and yeah, they're starting to grow out quite a bit. And like, yeah, see? That's when it grows out like that, that's when like my hair starts to get caught. So I think it's time to change them up. So when you order nails from Nails by Joe Fish, you'll get your nails and then you get your application kit, which is your buffer, your file, your nail glue, your cuticle pusher, and tabs. Today I'm going to be using tabs because that's all I use. I don't use the nail glue. But I have a bunch of tabs that I've been using, so I'm going to use those up first, depending on what size my nail is. And we're going to show you what I do when I'm putting on a new set. And then we'll get into painting some nails. I was thinking maybe Friday, maybe if people are interested, we'll do like a paint-along character for Christmas. And everybody can like post a picture of their thing and, you know, make a little collection of them. It's an idea. But I guess... I could put some music on for you guys in the background, obviously. Hopefully it's not too loud for you guys. Let me know if it's too loud. Now, so I got my nice fresh pair of nails here, but I already have a set of nails on. So, how do I go about going from this to this? What I do is, I know, my way might be a little weird to everybody. Hello, Sandy. Welcome in. Welcome in. Hopefully you're having a fantastic Tuesday. First, I'm just going to show you how I take and put on my press-ons, because I kind of need this video to put on my website and stuff. Because, you know, it's the number one question I get asked. How do you do this? So, I will show you how I do it. So first I take the back end of my cuticle pusher and I just come into the pocket. I also push down here a bit so that way I can, like I said, I've had these on for 3 weeks, so I'm expecting the glue to be very well stuck. And this is only with the tabs, no glue. But look at that, it's gross, right? Ew, how can you reuse that? You take the pointy end, put it in, and hopefully I'm close enough for you guys. It's hard trying to do it without making it dark. You know what, maybe I tilt this light. Can you guys see that better? So I come in, and I roll, and roll, and roll. Now you can use an alcoholic wipe and clean up anything on the background of it. And we do this. And look at that. Brand new, clean, ready to reuse. And I've had those on for 3 weeks. So what I normally do is I'll take the thumb off, because that's what I'm doing. I'll put this thumb there. Now sometimes it'll work here where like you can do the same rolling method, but sometimes it's just a little too stuck onto your nail. And don't mind if you find grossness on this, because like I said, I had these on 3 weeks, so who knows what could be hiding under these nails. But sometimes you can just go like this and peel it off if you can't roll it off. I know you're saying, but look, your nails are all gross and damaged looking. I promise you they won't be. So I took off some of the glue that I could by hand. Then you go in with your buffer. And what I like to do is kind of do like a circle movement on it when the glue is on there. Now if this is your first time putting it on, all you have to do is buff your nails to take away a bit of the shine and give it some something to attach to. But if you have glue on, you might want to do some circle movements just to really, you know, get the glue off. And don't forget, definitely buff the edges, because you know you want it to stick nicely all the way around. Right, and then you come in with your good old alcohol wipe. And look at that. I was like, wait. Brand new. I do have a little bit of glue in the corner there by the looks of it. And then, you know, if you don't have nails on, you can do this part first. Just pushing back your cuticles. But I like to do it after I take off. When you're taking off a set, I like to do it after, because sometimes, you know, you get some glue stuck in the sides here. And then I'll just now, if you wanted to at this point, you know, because you just took off a set, you might want to fix up your side walls. You're gonna do that. You know, you can fix up your however shaped you liked it underneath. You could trim them shorter if you want to. Totally up to you. I'm just going to grab this one because this is the alcohol pads that come with it. You can open it up. Now after you alcohol wipe it, you do not want to touch this nail to put any oils back on it before you apply it. And you don't want to touch water an hour before you do nails and then an hour after nails for it to really adhere. That's why most of the time you won't see me do it, but I'll do it at nighttime so that way doesn't. Now, my favorite thing that does not come with your kit is get your trusty tweezer kit. I like this one, the pointy one. And what you do is you measure your nail bed to the tip, which obviously goes this way. But I already know which one fit because, well, I've been doing this a while, but, oh, maybe not this one. Maybe not this one. That one got a dog fur in it, and I don't want that on my nail. Why don't I have another one? Come on. There we go. And with the tweezers, because it's easier to, like, maneuver it around. Then I come in. I go over to the one side. Like that. And then I push it down and over. Make sure I cover my nail. Give it a nice rub. So it's nice and sticky icky. Then I take it off one nice little whoosh. Now if there's anything that you, if you sized your nails first and like they were a little too big when they came, you can always come in and file off some sides and some edges, do whatever, you know, you need to do. But then I come in, I put it where the cuticle is, but then I come down just a little bit of it because, you know, this nail has room to maneuver. And then you just put your pressure down. And sometimes I'll even go in here and push my nail up against it if I have longer nails. Mind you, I did get over my skin on this cute thing, but if you do get some on your skin, you can always just take that off. Some of the adhesive tab. It's actually very easy to pull off. Because I do that from time to time if I didn't get right over to the one side. That's why I always like to start on the one side. And there you go. Nice on there. Now obviously I won't show you step by step of every single one. I'm just going to do them quickly. But I just wanted to have it there for people to see. But that's what I do. And you can put your cuticle oil on in like an hour's time. But just put it down here more. And then rub it up. That way the oil doesn't get under the sticky tab. But let's change these out quickly. You found some good tabs. Anytime I use them, mine pop right off. Right? These are... Like, look, I just put this tab on. Like, you guys watched. I'm pulling. And I like them because they're not perforated. So, they're easy to come on and on. They are a little on the thicker side. But not too thick. I don't know if you can see the thickness. It's not too bad. But I do like them. But like I said, I've had these on 3 weeks. And like, look. Like, they're stuck to my nail. And like, they stick onto the press-on's really good. As you can see. And like I said, we come in. I always clean up my nails when I put them back. So that way the next time I want to put them on, I don't have to clean them. So I just... twist, and look at that, brand new, ready to wear again. I think that's the one thing I do like. That's cause like when I did Hezeka, I don't know if you guys remember when I did that one, and I had to shave them off. I was so upset because it was so good. I had wished I put them on a press on. And that's the thing. As you do this more often, you get faster at it. So, like, maybe the first time it takes you, like, 20, 30 minutes to put on yourself. But as time goes on, you get used to how to do it like anything else. It doesn't take long at all. You just want to make sure that the old glue is off. I do have my cuticle cutters here because I might have to cut a couple cuticles. Don't recommend cutting your cuticles because you don't want to have exposure. Even though, you know, you're not using... products to cure and get in there. You don't want to cut up your cuticles. But I know that because it's been 3 weeks, I've got some growth that I might have to take off. And I'm showing you this step right now, but like sometimes if I want to get my cuticles, if there's something really stuck, I will pull out, which obviously Nova's been playing with it again, so it's not where I put it, but I will pull out this guy. Oh, can you tell Nova's been playing with it? Ugh. I'll take out this guy. Damn, that sanding band has some gunk on it. Thanks, because I know he was rolling it in his hair and stuff. So, ugh, come on, this one is just dirty. Why are you making it so? So I'll come in here with this. Sometimes if I'm having trouble, lightly sand it. But the one I do like to use for this one is not this bit. I wonder if I have the bit handy. Of course, nothing's ever handy, right? Because I normally do this off stream. Oh, come on. Where's my bits? So, I will take this one, this little circle one. And sometimes the bits are a little bit of a struggle getting in and out of this one. This is just some cheap brand one. Eventually I'm going to invest in a decent one. Okay, got it off. Got it off my sand band. So, I'll put this one in. Funny thing is, I'll plug this into my computer, I guess, because mine is a USB port. So, if you have one of these, obviously this makes your nail prep a little faster. But if you don't, you can just go with the regular, you know, one that you're used to. The regular, good old-fashioned, how we all started, nail file. Gotta make sure it's on the right direction, which I probably don't know if it's on the right direction, because, well, like I said, Nova was playing with it. But you can come in and take off the dead skin. I'm not as good with my left hand. This is where I should have showed it on my right hand. But it's, you know, it happens. But this one helps clean up your cuticles. I just don't know if I had it in the right direction. But as you can see, I'm taking off the dead skin here. This is what I do, how I do mine most of the time, because that way you don't even have to use the snippers, as I like to call the cuticle snippers or whatever the heck they're called. I'm bad with names. Oh, and I've got so much dust on me. So I came in with that, my favorite little cuticle bit. And look at that. And think about it. I've been wearing press-ons since... When did I start? Was it June was when I started doing events? And like... Not bad at all. And I wear press-ons every day. These nails are always gotta be on. If not, nippers. Thank you, paint and polish. If not, you see this white piece? That's called nail biter heaven. So, if I see that, my husband knows. If a nail pops off or something happens, on the off chance, he knows. Do not talk to me until I fix my nail, because if not, I'm not going to have nails. So how you size your nail, I guess I forgot to do that. You come in, this one's a little too small. I want a little bigger of a nail. That looks about right. That one's about right. So, like I said, you come in, you measure your nail, you grab it, pinch it off. And then, like I said, I attach it to one side, then I roll over to the other side, push it down. And And then just grab my tweezers. And pop it off. Yeah, I have a garbage can beside me. And then... Now, if you want to make sure, because I have nails that kind of go crooked sometimes, so sometimes I'll put them in front of me to try and make sure. That's the one thing about press-ons, though. If you put it on crooked, you can always take it back off and redo it. It's not like, you know, when you do it at the, when you're doing it at the salon, and you're like, oh, this is all crooked. Ooh, I kind of like this pink color on myself. Yes, Kayla has her birthday nails on. She wants to show off. She did them herself. She wanted to do her own birthday nails this year with her birthday glitter.
I did my birthday nails last year.
No, didn't I do them? Because you're 16.
I know. I did the first hand and you did the other hand. Because I think, was that one of the times that I almost passed out?
That's when we were doing the gel nails. Beautiful. Now we go on to the next nail. I won't show you step by step unless you guys still want it. Cute painting polish. Yeah. I like her little. She used her sparkles from that, her birthday sparkles from Tracy last year.
The purple sparkles. I love those.
She says she loves them. But I won't go in detail on every nail now, unless somebody says, "Hey, can you show me this again or something?" Because I don't want to bore you with the same old, same old. But like I said, like you see these, like. Like you see here. Yeah, and there's some taco meat.
Garlic dip.
Oh, you can have garlic dip with it. I'm just saying Dad made taco meat with it. That's what. And then we roll. This rolling technique, though, for cleaning the nails, so great. I'm like, you wouldn't even think I've worn these nails because they're not damaged at all. Oh, did I throw out my... No, oh, there's one there. Okay. And then we're going to... Like I said, we're going to try and do this nail, because I want to do this set for myself. But I think we're going to do, like, more Christmas bulby kind of vibes on the tree. I don't know. Funny thing is, normally I put a paper towel down. I didn't think today.
So what are we doing nail-wise? We just put in...
I don't know, I'm gonna do this one, but I'm gonna put more like Christmas bulby on the background of it.
Ooh! And you're doing them on mountain peaks?
I'm doing them on myself, for myself.
Yeah, on mountain peaks.
Yes, on mountain peaks.
You are obsessed with mountain peaks.
I do like the mountain peaks now, because I can actually like close my hands better. Oh. The only problem is it does get stuck in the mouse wheel sometimes. I know, I have it, for a nail biter, it's great, but, like, at the same time, it's like, I gotta cover this before I get in on this again.
I know, it's so tempting. That's why, like, sometimes when I sleep with it, I'm, like, waking up, and I'm like, do I still have nails?
Nope, this is why I won't go to sleep without my nails being covered. I would
risk it for the biscuit.
Risk it for the biscuit?
Yeah.
I see. Like I said.
What's Thursday? Oh no, I mean.
Thursday, you're at school all night.
Thursday, Ramona's a stream, okay?
What?
Ramona's
Thursday. Thursdays, no, not usually.
Let's go! Tell him not to do surprise Thursday stream.
Well, I can't tell him not to stream.
Yep.
Do I look like I'm his wife? Take it up with his wife. Maybe.
Then I have, like, all the fresh food.
We're gonna stream raid IRL.
Yeah, we're literally gonna be there in person and see the actual garden, a petite garden.
This nail's got a little funkiness going on here with growth, so I'm just gonna tidy that up.
Wow, Mom. It's still November. I can't believe you're taking off your epilepsy nails.
It is still November, but I've had them on for 3 weeks. I gotta change them up a little bit. I know, I need that side. I'm back. Nail clicker extreme here. Okay. Like I said.
Oh, mom, I finished the dance and I played.
Okay, good.
Sorry, I keep talking.
Oh, come on. Dang, nabbit. This is why. If I ever do build myself a nail room, the dogs will not be allowed in there. Okay. Like I said, I come in on the corner. Oh, I almost got right on the cuticle that time. I usually try to put a little gap in between here, but there's a little gap around the whole outer tab that I'm usually placing it great. So if these ones pop off, it's because I guess the nerves are describing how to do it. But see, like this, when I know the tab is here, sometimes I'll cut this nail shorter because I'll leave it right to the tip of the tab. Like I said, after an hour, then you can touch water again. But I don't like to touch water with my nails. So I used to hate wearing gloves. But because I'm using the adhesive tabs and with hot water, eventually they do become a little less sticky. I try to wear gloves when I'm doing the dishes all the time now. And I've gotten used to wearing gloves now. That now if I accidentally don't put my gloves on, I'm like, oh, my gloves! So, you know, it's a lifestyle learning just like everything else. So how's everybody's day doing? Everybody having a good day? Sandy, did you eat lunch? Probably not. It's probably too early for your lunch yet. Or no, it's lunchtime. I'm eating now. Ordered Mediterranean food. That sounds delicious. I like Mediterranean food. I love cultural food, so I like having every kind of cuisine. Oh, I didn't realize I cut this one in such a, like, awkward shape. That's probably because I cut it after I put the sticky heel on the last time, but it's not something I usually worry about. I love getting food from the places. It's really good. So what'd you get, like a salad, a wrap? I love Mediterranean shawarma. Oh my goodness. That is my jam. Okay. Since I'm running out of some of these sizes here, I'm going to have to open my new tab that I threw in here for the stream purpose. Okay. So it is this corner one. So there is one. Okay, I don't have to open that one yet. Okay. really feel shaky much. Yeah, I think tonight I'm treating myself. I think we're getting Wendy's because we were gonna treat ourselves last night, but the hubby's paycheck didn't come in because I forgot that there was a holiday. So last night we had plant-based burgers because, you know, like I said, we got some stuff from the food bank and it was like, I'm not a plant person. Like, I love my vegetables, don't get me wrong, but I'm a meat eater, so they didn't taste right to me. They taste better than they did back in the day, mind you. Like, they're at least swallowable compared to back in the day. Back in the day, they taste like cardboard. But there's just this weird taste that gets stuck in my throat, and I just can't do it. Nova, on the other hand, he didn't mind them as much. But, you know, that's kids for you. Me, I was like, my husband, he refused to eat last night. He was like, nope, I'll starve. That's okay. I am not eating that. So I said, okay, when we get paid, we'll do one eat out. And then the rest has to go to bills. Wendy's is supposed to be the plan. Because that was supposed to be last night's plan. So one good eat out. And then there's nothing for another month. So tonight is treat dinner. But it's pretty sad that I saw a TikTok today. And it's true. Like, it's pretty sad that groceries cost the same amount almost as eating out now. Like, that's ridiculous. Like, you're almost forcing people to eat out in some weird way. So yeah, I'm gonna get Wendy's tonight. Might regret that decision later, but meh. I think once a month everyone's allowed to have something that the kids like that I don't have to cook. It's funny because you said these are called nippers. I call them cuticle cutters because nippers are what I call nail cutters. But I guess all the same difference, just cutting something to do with nails, right? Oh, come on. I didn't put you there. I put you in the garbage. And just like that, we went from this to this. Now, I'll do this one even faster because I am right-hand dominant. Who's calling now? No phone calls during streaming. Thank you, goodbye. Like I said, I'm right-hand dominant, so this should be faster. That's why I always start with the last one. Those are pretty. Why, thank you. We do the kind of like the plaid underneath. Then we added some snowflakes. I know, I might be boring you by putting nails on today and not decorating nails yet, but we're getting there, I promise. Just if I'm going to do my nails and not touch water for an hour, I might as well do them all. Like I said, sometimes you can just come in like this, too. And just roll the glue off. Now, obviously with nail glue, you kind of can't do that. Like I said, nail biter's heaven is all those spots. Did you guys buy anything from the YN sale? Not yet. There's still time. But have I yet? No. Because, like I said, my paycheck got delayed by a day. And I don't know. I have to do the domestic shipping, and I know it's $24.99, but I have to see what sale tax and duties are on top of that. I might have to hold on to my gift cards till later, but hey, at least in the new year, we'll have we should be able to order online, which then I'm going to be in the same boat as all you guys, because then once I can order off the website, there's no holding me back. It's just talking to people on the phone, hold, you know. Placing an order on phone is a lot more, what's the word I'm looking for? A lot more challenging than ordering over the thing, because, you know, I guess the mystery boxes are definitely the easiest to order over online, because you just say mystery box, small, medium, or large. But there's other things where, like, it's better if you know the code. So I'm looking forward to being able to order online. I didn't get anything. I was out shopping when Greg showed what was in the boxes. I had time to think about it, and I really don't need what's inside. Oh, is that because when you calculated all the stuff you spent? Sandy, is that because when you calculated what you spent this year, you were like, oh, I gotta hold off a bit? Or is it that you're just that stockpiled right now? I totally get it. I was thinking about it, but like, I was like, okay, money is tight. I wanted to give the kids an eat out night. Theoretically, I could just cook and not do an eat out night. And then I can buy the small box with the gift codes, but I was like, you know what? Do I need it? No. Do I want it? Yes. Because I can work with what I got for now. Eventually, obviously, I'm going to need to up some colors and stuff, because as you guys know by watching me struggle at the bottom of some bottles. But it's like, I don't know. I was thinking about the small box. If anything, the small box. Like, I also wanted to try the medium box only to try the tips out, but I was like, that's a crack in my nail. So I'm going to cut that shorter again. Watch. Now I won't find my nail clippers. That won't surprise me. That won't surprise me. Things always go missing from my table when I need them. And I'm pretty sure I didn't put them in here. Oh, but, nope, that's not it. That's my part of my phone. Oh, come on. Did I throw them back in here? Funny thing is, you let the kids and husband touch your stuff sometimes, things will go missing. Especially nail clippers. Oh, come on. Oh, shush. I gotta bring out the dresser so I can organize this stuff better. Lately I'm getting very disorganized. I'm sure all your stations get like this from time to time. I'm pretty sure I'm not the only one. Okay, well, I can't find them, so don't do what I do. I saved up all year to shop during the holidays. I'm stocked up. I have the lamp. Wait, I haven't yet. I have a gift code. I'm allergic to henna, and I never do acrylics. I have a portable e-fry on the light, so I need nothing but a 2X sweatshirt and have it not fit. Yeah, I was looking at the sweatshirt too, because I was like, see, this is where if I had fiber gel, I would use that to fix this crack. But, you know. And then wear that under the press on. Because I also found people that don't have, like, curves or whatever. What are they called? Oh my goodness. See, my brain is not working today, but, you know, sometimes, it, like, if the nail's not fitting you properly, you can put a little build up underneath it to make it, like, fit a little better. Some people's nails are just so flat. The arch. But I think I got it that time. Hopefully it won't split no more, but it might split one more time. But that's okay. I know I smashed this one in a door. That's why it split. So it's not the end of the world. But it does make me feel bad when I go this low on a nail. I'm like, I bet I didn't nail bite it. But, you know, I didn't. And I'll hide it, and it'll grow. C-curve. Yes, that's it. Oh, hello, W2. Welcome in. W2 Swinner. Hope you're having a fantastic Tuesday. I'm just starting off by showing how I change my press-ons, which is being a slow process today. Because I'm not finding everything that I want. But, you know, it happens. And that's the one thing. I hate the t-shirts. I hate the sweatshirts they're using. Me, I'm a bigger... Okay. Don't want to sound inappropriate. Hopefully this doesn't come off inappropriate to anybody. But I'm a bigger breasted person, okay? So most sweaters, like, even if I get them 3X, they're choking me because, well, my bust is a little too big. So I prefer zip-up sweaters. For that reason. Did you see the peacock had Five Nights at Freddy? Yes, W2 Swinner. Sandy, because we don't get peacock in Canada. Sandy actually lent me hers to watch it with the kids. So thanks to her, we got to watch it. They were super excited. Kayla didn't want to watch it in the dark, though. She was like, it's going to have jumps, but it didn't even have very many jump scares, but she was afraid that it was going to have jump scares. And then I said, well, what were you going to do if we went to a theater to watch this? But we did get to watch it. And Michaela was a little upset with me because yesterday I started binge watching Christmas movies. because, well, after my doctor's appointment and my AC1 being at 6.5, I was kind of upset with myself. Maybe I should have tried harder because I knew coming off the one drug that this was going to happen. But I was like, I just want to sit down and binge Christmas music movies. So that's what I did. Yeah, I used that today. 1 year of consistent set directly started growing in with a C curve again, right? Sometimes you just need a little bit of help. But see, for that crack nail, I think I might have got the crack this time, but we'll see as it grows out. If it splits again, yeah, it'd be nice to have something like fiber gel to kind of like hold it in place while I'm growing it out and get it fixed. But at least it's not bent now. Before, because I smashed it, it was all bent in. Oh, sorry, it was bent out because that's the way the nail went. So, like, my nail was coming with a big, like, bump coming out of here. But I've been slowly cutting it back and letting it do its thing. And now it's looking pretty decent. Just sucks because, you know, it's a nail biter. Looks like I went back to biting my nails. But it's okay. Slow progress. Slow progress is better than no progress, right? What one did I say it was? This first one? Yeah. See, this is where I kind of messed up because I had to cut it. Now I'm going to have a little overlap of the glue. But it's okay, I can take it off after. Hey, both. It fits pretty good, so I bought the same size the next sale, and it was too small. Oh, no way. 30 years of nail chewing. No, 30 years of nail chewing. Not biting, chewing, because my nails grow in flat. And seriously, these both are finally correcting. Nice, you know, like, stress, like, especially, like, the last 2 weeks I've had. If it wasn't for these press-ons, there'd be nothing left to, like, my nails were so bad when my friend started them. Like, they were, like, I had this much nail. Literally. That's all I had. When I first started growing my nails, that's all I had. Stubs. Not even stubs. She was like, how am I even going to put gel over this to help you? She's like, I don't even know what to do with your nails. I was like, well, you said you wanted a test dummy to practice on. I'm like, I'm your greatest practice dummy. You can get me from nail biting to having nails? You're a winner. Which she did. And then when she was like, I'm moving, I was like, uh-oh. I gotta figure out what I'm doing. So that's what started me in on this business. And then I was going to open my own salon doing gel nails, because I'm more into gel than I am acrylics. Which I get that vibe that a lot of people are more into gel than acrylics, but a couple of my friends are all like now, oh no, shellac. I'm like, I don't like shellac. I don't know why, but I don't like it. I like gel. But, you know, to each its own. But then when Kayla started using these and saying that these tabs were lasting, like I said, I had this on 3 weeks. Like, you think this would be a struggle to get off. This wouldn't be a struggle. This would be popping off. And I'm literally, like, look. So, like, that's just tabs. Yes, they come loose with hot water. So, like, sometimes if you're having a really nice, long, hot shower, you might have to fix one or two. But, yeah, you expect those things with tabs. Just like, you know, people whose acrylics or gel pop off. Because you never know the chemical balance of your nail beds. See, look at this one. Nail biter. Can you believe that? That's the longest nail I have. Shellac is CND's gel. Often just means gel. Really? Because my friend was doing shellac on me and her mom was like, no, you do gel on her. Her nails do better for gel. Because when she started my nails the year before that, before COVID happened, gel was giving me, like, she was impressed because I was coming in every 6 weeks and I could, mind you, the growth would be like right at the end, but not one nail was ever damaged and then they were just kept growing like snakes. I do gel because I don't have a dishwasher. Acrylic was always popping off, lifting halfway up the nail. Yeah, I use a bit of both. A bit of dishwasher and a bit of hand washing. But when I hand wash now, I use gloves for press-ons. So that implements my, like, gel use before. Gel was fine, but now that I'm using press-ons, because I do like to wash in really hot water, I just use the gloves. Now, like I said, you don't have to use this tool. I just use it because I like it for cleaning up my cuticles. And because, obviously, if I was doing gel overlays, you know, even if you change the press-ons when you're doing your nail prep, you still go back to what you've learned. Did you do the mystery boxes this year? Not officially yet. I'm just waiting to see what the budget will allow. I just have to pay some bills. I do have a couple gift codes, but for me, I'm looking at still having to pay for the, even if I just get just the small mystery box, I'm looking at even still paying an extra $20 on top of the $50 off I have for the $35, because shipping was $24.99. And then there's the taxes for duties. Get the large. The large is nice, I'm not gonna lie, but that's definitely not in my budget at this moment in time. I'd love to. It's just, it's currently not in my budget. Like I said, even buying the small one with the gift cards is a struggle. But I still might. I just have to see what's left in the account later. The funny thing is, I saved the gift cards so that this year I could at least buy one box. But if I don't, and this year's boxes, I've got to say, these ones are my favorite by far. Last year's, I was like, I didn't really miss too much. This year, I wanted to see how their tips are, because obviously being a press-on business, it'd be nice to see their tips, even though I know they're on a pricier range to do long-term. Because already that's $25 shipping added to it every time. So, I know it would be a little more on the pricier range over time. But, obviously, the more you ship, the price changes. Oh, see, I'm almost at the stage that I can almost cut some of this off now. But because this nail bed is a little smaller, I need the growth nail to fit the full sticky on. So this one still has to be quite long compared to the other ones. Same with my thumbs, but it's okay. I'm so excited for the requested thing was in the large. I got it too because my sister wants the one thing too for Xmas. It ended up being about $150 regular price on the site. Which thing in the large one? I'm pretty sure everybody here doesn't care about spoilers. Because if they did, oops, sorry, I might have already ruined some stuff. Hate me. Unfollow. Not spoiling it. But, you know, we've already talked about the fact that the light. And I obviously said the tips are in there. But I don't know how I feel about color tips, because all mine are clear. But like I said, it's to each everyone's own. But the only thing I like the amount of stuff that came in the small box, but I don't know if I'm down for the colors. The funny thing is, I'm sure that, I guess in the next couple days, you'll start seeing the boxes, besides the fact that Greg already showed. But I'm sure you're going to start seeing everybody that are getting their boxes, doing the unboxing. So soon the whole interweb is going to be flooded. And there'll be nothing anybody can do to avoid it. You literally will have to avoid the internet. Avoid all social platforms. But see, for someone like me ordering it, it's not going to get here for 2-3 weeks. Everybody would have theirs before I get mine. So there's no way I can unbox and spoil. I can only spoil by telling you what's in it on my streams. So if anyone hates me, oops. But I think this year people are more appreciative of the spoiling because of where all the prices of food and everything's gone up. Everyone's on a tighter budget this year, I think, compared to most any other year. The only thing is left the wireless. That's the other thing I would ask YN to come out with. Curious Guys one is ridiculously expensive. I feel like paying 50% for the light that half the brand name. Oh, guaranteed that's half the brand name. Guaranteed. Guaranteed. That's how anything is half the time is brand. You really think Nike shoes cost that much to make? You think your Louis Vuitton purse cost that much to make? No, you're literally, everything is always paying for the brand. And that's how everything is. But I'm not gonna lie. Some brands are worth the investment. Because, sometimes you just have to. This is the longest time it's taken me to do my nails, guys. Literally. Most time in the beginning. Even this is kind of... Oh, I didn't put that one kind of straight. Oh, this one might be the one I have to fix later. But the first time I did my nails took me 40 minutes. I've been streaming for an hour, but I get it. I was showing detail of how to do it and stuff, but never spent this long doing my nails. I guess it's different when, you're not going into detail or showing or making sure you're in camera. You're just plopping them on and plopping them off. Okay. Now, you can soak this in hot water to help you get them off. I'm just too lazy to do that. I'm just being quite honest. That this is how I normally do it because I'm too lazy. But if you're one of those people that have severe pain tolerance and the sticky might get stuck a bit, you might want to put it in a little bit of maybe olive oil and dish soap. To grease up the sticky the tab. But because this is, me and this is something I do. This doesn't hurt or bother me at all. Kayla does it the same way too now. First time I did it for her, I was afraid, so I put her in soapy water. With a little bit of olive oil to help release the stickiness. And obviously warm water. Okay, I'm gonna plug this now. I don't need that in my computer to get tangled up in. Okay. But, like, I'm impressed. For a nail biter, my sticky tabs, like, my nails come out really nice. But mind you, my nails, like I said, they are very brittle. Like, I don't know if you can see this, but, like, they fold in half. Oh, of course, I can't show it. Because they're so thin. Like, it's hard to show it, but, like, I can literally fold them. So that's why I cover them up. Cover your nails! No, I wanted the smaller one. That one. Do I have that one? Oh, I do! Sweet. But my nail beds have started to get a little wider too now that I'm not biting them. It's been a nice change. They're looking a lot healthier than they ever did in my life. It's even crazier to think, you know, my press-ons are helping my nail growth. But I know as soon as I take these if I ever stop wearing press-ons and don't go, like, back to gel, it's over. It's over, I tell you. All the progress I've made over the year will be gone. Okay. And that's it. Both hands are done. It's tea time. Mmm. It'll be Pepsi time by the time I've been streaming. So, look at that. I wore those for 3 weeks. I can rewear them all over again. See? That's the one thing I like. Because I can't say that every time I went to a salon that I could put back on a set that I really liked. Because even if I asked the same nail artist to paint the exact same set again, it'll always have some form of differences. Okay. Let's tidy up and get into our nail set for today. Sorry, guys, to bore you with how I put on press-on nails. Okay. I hate days that I have to work. I get so tired right now, and I still have to work 2 hours less than ever since I got COVID for the first time. I haven't been able to do 8 hours without wanting to crash. Yeah, I know. COVID messed it up. I think COVID messed it up systems for real. The metal bottom. I bought it for six. Oh, it was less than. Ooh, nice. Yeah, I think I'm over the Christmas months if I have extra money, or I'm just gonna save for next year. But I'm gonna start looking at a light, because by the time I can actually afford one, I guarantee you YM won't have them. Sorry, just cleaning up the desk from all my nonsense. Okay, now, let's get into our nail prep. Like I said, I think we're going to go with this one for my next Christmas set. But I think I'm going to make more like Christmas bulbs on the tree. So we'll see. Okay. I cut off all my growth and put on a fresh set because I do dimensional. Yeah. Well, that's the thing, like, when I was doing gel nails, I was just filling in, but every so often, because my nails start to grow, like, curved down, or, you know, you just know, like, it's time to regrow it out again and restructure it. But every so often, like, but because I was a nail biter, every time I got a little bit of growth, I was like, no, don't cut. Let's just fill in. We'll just file them nicer. We'll start to pick a shape. Which is usually coffin. That's the thing. If I do quit press-ons and go back to doing gel, I don't know if I want to shape my nails like this. It's almost too much work. But, you know, it happens. I'm trying a new pinky size this time because I've noticed that my nail growth is a little wider now. So I want to try one size and see if I like it. That's the thing with growing from your nail biter. Sometimes you're going to have to change the shaping of your press-ons because as you grow, you're getting your nail beds wider. Because they're growing to what they're supposed to look like. I watched Christmas in the Pines yesterday. Yes, I'm full blown into... I haven't decorated for Christmas yet, but I'm full blown into watching feel-good movies. Full blown. I watched The Grinch with Nova. I watched Christmas in the Pines. Nova actually watched that one with me. As Michaela says, the rom-coms. I just found out a dear friend of mine was diagnosed with Alzheimer's. I tried to call her yesterday and found out she doesn't have a phone anymore because she forgot how to use one. Oh, that's sad. I know, my grandfather was diagnosed with it and watching him near the end, which the funny thing is my whole stepmom's side of the family, they all get Alzheimer's before they pass. So we joke around with her, and to her it's a joke. Like, it's the only way we can do it. We always tell her, well, we know when you're almost going. And she'll just, like, be like, be quiet. I was like, don't worry, we'll have you in at home by then. But yeah, it's hard because, like, my grandfather thought my daughter was my stepmom's, and I didn't exist. So I was always a stranger. So it's like, it's hard to see somebody that, like, especially when they were, like, you know, it's your stepmom, right? It's her parents. So, like, he never treated you any differently. You were treated the same. And then to see him, like, not remember who you are, it's rough. So I can imagine, like, you know, especially seeing a friend or family member go through it. It's never pretty. Your nails are growing narrower. I think because I had them bit into, like, stubs. And, like, they weren't all the way out to where my nail buds are. A couple of mine have gotten wider. The ends, though, when they come out, they're a little more narrower. But I'm not finding that my nails are getting narrower. It's like I'm getting... they're coming out to, I guess, where they naturally were supposed to be. But how am I supposed to know I was a nail biter? Only the nails I saw were acrylics or... Well, when I was younger, it was acrylics, and then as I got older and I found out about gel, it was a little different. Not my first rodeo with dementia, but the first I've seen, heard it's bad. All my friends still know how to telephone work. Well... It trust me, it's not a fun battle at all to see someone go through it. My grandfather loved his boat, which was, you know, connected to an ocean. Because, hello, we live in Newfoundland, you're surrounded by the Atlantic Ocean. And he'd wander off and go down to his boat. And we couldn't risk him taking the boat out by himself. And... family had to step in and sell his boat on him, and at first he'd be still down at the dock and be like, where's my boat? But we had to do it for his safety. But it's hard to see the man's prized possession, the one thing in life he loved You know? That was his passion. He built his boat. He took his family out on boat all the time. Like, there's many times as a kid I remember, like, the whole family would get together on the boat and go out for dinner. And have dinner at sea. So, like, to see that I have to take it away from a 70-year-old man, you know, who worked hard his whole life, and be like, yeah, well, the one thing you cherish and want most in life, you can't do no more. Just because even if someone in the family kept it and, like, took him out with it, if it was tied up to the wharf down there, he would get at it. So it was just, it was time it had to go. And, you know, I felt bad. I'm not gonna lie. I understood, like, yes, I understand why the family's doing it and, like, that stuff, but it was just, it's hard to see. So, yeah, I totally get it. Like, it's different when it's like, though, oh, I forgot, like, when I forgot something, you know, the small progression leading up to it sometimes, but some people don't get the small progression. Some people just wake up one day and they start forgetting things. And it's horrible. There's, like, one kid that I saw on TikTok and stuff that he'd always take his mom out for lunch, and she'd be like, you're such a nice guy, and she would never remember him. And I was like, that's hard. Like, not only is it hard for, like, you to witness, that's hard for you to go through. Because all you want to do there is, like, help that person, but, you know, you can't make somebody remember. That's why they said, like, having dolls and stuff as you're older, like, taking care of a fake baby helps with Alzheimer's and dementia and stuff. I was like, well, I think I'm gonna buy me some dolls. Now, I don't know if that is actually true, but scientifically, that's what they're saying helps. So, I don't know. Oh, look, I forgot to add these to my collection, because these are all my press-ons. Can you see? I've got to get a better display case. Because I've got a bunch of sets just sitting in a Ziploc bag to reuse. These are all ones I've worn. I don't play with dolls as a kid. I can't imagine starting now. Well, that's what they say. Like, let your parents babysit the kids, right? Like, the grandkids. I guess it's something with being fun and young. I don't know. There's a game that same can help you keep your mind strong, right? There's a lot of those types of games out there. I've played a few of them. But sometimes playing them, I'm like, you're keeping my mind strong, but you're currently ticking me off. I'm like, oh, like I was playing with a game with Nova the other day. It's this shark game. I forget what it's called, but it'll ask you questions like animals that start with G, and like you got to come up with the words and not get eaten by the shark to build the planks to get up higher. And I'm sitting there going, and then he's like, "Mom, how do you spell giraffe?" I'm like, "You're asking the wrong person." I'm like, "You know how to spell better than I do." He's like, "But I don't want to get it wrong because then I'll lose the round." I'm like, "Well, you don't want me typing anything. I won't type you. I will type you into the sharks." And even though I suck at spelling entirely, I was interested playing that with him. Oh my goodness, my English. I don't know how to English, guys. The only language I know. With a je petit français. But I don't know enough French. I just know enough French how to order food. And how to ask for where the bathroom is. That's about it. You know, that's about all I know how to ask. Soup de légumes. Mushroom soup. Uh-huh. Yeah. Soup du jour. Soup of the day. Fromage. Anything with cheese. I'll just say fromage. Usually they point you to things that have cheese in them. My French is so good. The funny thing is, I remember most of my colors in French. But there's a lot of French that, like, the kids will come home and be like, oh, we learned this in school today. I'm like, what does that mean again? Like, oiseau. I was like, bear? I didn't realize it was a bird. My favorite one was a cochon, which is a pig. But yes, my French is very little. just know how to ask for the bathroom and eat food. Which, those are the most crucial things, right? The only things we need to know. My prediction is I'm going to be halfway through this bottle before the end of stream. 1.5 liters, no big deal. Just having a thirsty day. I can't even have a part-time job. His dad has no sense of time management. Wasn't really about that great. Oh no, that is terrible. That, oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, I'm sorry that that happened. My goodness. That's like my grandma. They're trying to get her outside more and stuff, but you know, she stopped going places because she couldn't go. She'd have a lot of washroom accidents. You know, as the body gets older, you know, things don't work the same way. So she would be afraid to go out and, like, not eat if she had to go to a doctor's appointment and stuff. And a couple times, you know, her legs were getting a little weaker. So this summer, they actually built a wheelchair ramp onto her house to get her out better. So at least now she can go outside, maybe in the garden or something, instead of just being cooped up in a house. So my grandfather, my uncle, they built the ramp this summer for her. So I'm hoping she gets good use out of it and actually gets outside a bit. Poor guy, I feel so bad for my sister's parents. He can't go anywhere without or do anything because 100% of the time is wrapped in his parents. That's the thing. That's why, like, I totally, like, I've already had this discussion with my kids after watching my grandfather go through it. That, you know, I don't want them to feel obligated to take care of me if I start having dementia or Alzheimer's. Just, you know, put me in a home. I know you might feel bad because I know there are some bad homes, but I don't want to put them on the burden of that they can't live their life or do things with their kids because they're, you know, stuck doing me. So that's what I told them. I said, please just, you know, I know you might be like, but Mom, you took care of me. I want to take care of you. You got your kids to take care of. Mom lived her life. She got to, you know, have you beautiful kids. It's time to, you know, you can come. I'm not saying don't come visit me. Like, hello, come visit me. Bring me my grandkids, even if I don't remember half of you. And if it's too hard for you, don't feel guilty that you can't show up. But I don't want them to have to deal with that, I guess you'd say. So they're trying to keep her somewhere familiar as long as possible. Yeah, for sure. I totally get that too, but I just like saying, like, for my own thing, I'm like, I just don't want to put that on my kids. But I get it. The other route, you know, they don't want to see that. But, you know, it's one of those things you got to weigh your options. And you have to choose what's best for you and best for your family. Just like everything. That's like me and my husband. We've had the talk of life support too. Because my mother's been on life support twice now. She's come back off of it twice. But it was because that had happened. We had had the discussion of, you know, if it came to the time, you do what you have to do. There's no point in, you know, making a higher hospital bill for nothing. So we've had the talks that you don't want to talk about. But, you know, you rather have those talks and understand each other's wishes. So that way, you know, maybe that other person, you know, in case they can't communicate with you, that, you know, you're doing right by them. So we've had some pretty deep, tough discussions on what we want. But I totally get it. Like, each person is different, right? That's why I always say there's many scenarios that fit many different people. You just have to do what fits for you. Like, my grandmother's wanted to be in a home for a long time. She has home care, so someone that comes in for, what, an hour to 3 hours every day. Helping with some, like, cleaning. But that's why when my uncle retires this year, he's going back down to help them, because we're all up here, so when he retires at the end of this year, he's going down to help them. But my grandmother has wanted to go into a home for the last 5 years. My grandfather, he's like the jack of all trades, and, like, you know, they built that house. It burnt down in a forest fire before my dad was born, and they rebuilt it. You know, they have their histories and their memories, and he's not ready to give up his shop of doing his wooden projects or planting his garden. Like I said, the man got his moose license this year. What are we painting today? I'm gonna do this nail for myself because I did it for a customer, but she wanted the darker version, but I really like the lighter version. So I'm doing this one, but I think I'm going to add Christmas bulbs to the tree. A little more, like, maybe red or green. Maybe even some blue. And then I might or might not put a nose on the deer. Deciding that part, the nose part. So I'm going to make my next Christmas set. I was thinking, if people would like to, maybe we could on Friday do pick a character and we can all paint together the character and see what everyone comes up with. It's no competition. I don't have the only shop I have is my website. It's I think it's / web, or is it website? No, let me see. Nope, so it must be. Oh, God, I put a D? That's why it didn't work? Thank you, W2. You figured it out. Yeah, I don't have a merch site, just my press-on-nail site. Just my press-on-nail site. Which, next week, we're doing a Black Friday sale of 35% off, so that's gonna be cool. Why? Oh, Hold on, I'm gonna have to put you on Be Right Back for a quick second. Oh, never mind. I didn't make the phone call in time. They'll leave a message. It might be my son. I already confirmed my son's, or my husband was supposed to. I hope he did confirm my son's appointment on Thursday with his endocrinologist. But what I was saying is I'm doing a 35% off sale on the 20th to the 27th. So today I was working on the back end setting up the sale, so that'll be fun. That will be fun. Once the channel gets a little bigger, I'll think about maybe putting some Nail Buddies on mugs or something for anyone that wants that. I actually don't have any 00 size yet. I haven't found a company that has the 00 size that doesn't cost me an arm and leg and shipping from the US. So the biggest size I have currently is a 0. So these ones are the mountain peaks. So 0 to 9 is pretty much what I have right now. I'm still looking for some bigger sizes because, you know, I have some, friends that are drag queens. They ship from France if you order from their site directly. Ooh, okay. So Gel X from France. I was gonna buy one off of the Amazon. I saw a couple, but they didn't have a shape that, the shapes that I want are always out of stock. So I keep checking back and checking back. I have wanted to buy the Gel X, but that's a good tip. I will go to the Gel X site and maybe try ordering from there and see what it's like. I just know that, like, ordering it, I've been trying to order off of the Canadian Amazon, and because I'm a coffin wearer mostly, but now I'm using the Mountain Peaks. The coffins are always sold out. As fast as they get restocked, they're, like, gone. I'll notice that they're in, and then I'm like, okay, let me go check my bank account. Okay, I get paid tomorrow, I'll order them. Next day go on, they're gone. And I'm like, seriously, why did they sell it so fast? But I get it, it is Gel X. So I haven't been able to invest in them yet. But they are on my bucket list. I want the ones just shown in medium. I want the ones you just showed in medium coffin. Oh, these? Or this thing that I'm doing today? I love the whole scheme, wintry without being too dark. Yeah, see, this is the inspo I came up with. So this is the one we're gonna do today. But I'm gonna try to do a thing. This one's actually in a medium coffin of the ones I have, but I guess you have a 00 now, so I'll see if I can get the Gel X for that. But this was my customer wanted. I gotta go in here. There's no name, don't worry. I'm just packaged it and hoped to ship it out this week. She wanted the darker one. And that to me, I like this lighter one a lot better. You have 00 thumbs? Okay, I'll check there's a couple nail salons, nail shops that you don't have to, that I can check out to see if they have it in. But like I said, they always have it in and have it out. But I'm going to try the France thing that you said. The actual Gel X site. I have short, fat fingers. Yeah, the funny thing is I'm in my medium ballerinas. That's almonds. Where's my medium ballerinas? That's my medium stilettos. That's medium squares. Oh my gosh. That's the ovals. I have a few different... We're working on different sizes and shapes. Because, like, I like to make everyone's nail ideas come to life, right? So, these ones... The funny thing is, when I'm using Mountain Peaks, I'm a 0. When I'm using these, I'm a 1. When I use the medium ballerinas. But Mountain Peaks, I'm a 0. I'm like... Oh, every shape and size has a different way it sits on your fingers. And my pinkies are 6. Yeah, I'm making a 6 on my Mountain Peak today because as my nail has gotten a little wider here, I don't know if you can see that, it's not fully covering. And with press-ons, you want them to fully cover, so I'm making this one a 6 today to see if it's going to look too big, and then I'll go back here if I have to, but I'm not too biggie. But I will definitely try and get a gel Xbox. See if I can get it in. And then I will let you know. I like the jeans they have to try. They're like jeans you have to try them on, right? Well, it took me I made a few sets because, like, I didn't want to take off my nails when I switched to Mountain Peaks. But I tried the hack that someone said, like, you know, use the silly putty. Or the, you know what I'm talking about, sticky tack. And you put the pitch, like, I was wearing coffins at the time. So you put the coffin that you're wearing and imprint it, and then you match it to the other shape. But it was totally off. It did not work for me the way that it said that it worked on TikTok. It did not work for me. So I'm like, But hopefully I can get it in soon. Hopefully I can find a shop that has it. That way, if you do order it during the Black Friday week, they'll be cheaper. Or maybe I'll just end up giving you the Black Friday deal when I get them in. Since I already know you want them ahead of time, I just have to find the right... nails. I don't like the technique for short. Yeah, that's the thing, like, for certain, my husband was helping me set up the sale for Black Friday next week. And he's like, this one doesn't have all the sizes in it. I said, because I cannot create this art on a small square or a custom square. Like, it won't fit. Which I realized, I put those ones up today, but I think I put up the short squares. I might have to change that, because I think I put up the short squares for those ones. And I don't know if I can fit that on a short square, because the short squares are like probably that. So you're not getting much of a tree. You're not getting much of nothing besides the animal. So, I don't know. We'll have to see. I'm going to have to go back in and check those. What technique don't you like for shorts? The checking it on Silly Putty to see a different shape? My middle finger is in Mountain Peaks is, mind you, I think I just polished all my nails, but it's okay, is a 3. No, sorry, this one's a 2. These two are 3s. And right now this one's on a 6, but I'm moving it to a 5 to see. Because I think a 5 might be better now that they've gotten a little more wider. But, you know, I'm always playing with things. The place. Okay. Yeah, I made that customer set using the quarter trick, but I already had pre-warned her that, like, okay, I don't know if I'm gonna try to get it, but, like, I don't know how well this, I've only used this quarter trick once before. I was like, but I'll send you a sizing kit, so that way next time you order, you can get the proper nails for yourself. But I do realize that I soon might have to make shaping kits for people so that maybe they can see what shape looks best for them. Because honestly, I was coughing from doing gels, and now that I've tried on these mountain peaks, I've kind of might have not been so much a coughing girl anymore. So, part of me thinks it's time to make the shape kits, because I haven't made them before because no one's requested them yet. But I think I might just get like do them all in size, like maybe a 4 or 5. Because I think 4s or 5s are on everyone's list, or maybe make some 6s. I don't know. I'm trying to figure out what size I should use that would kind of fit everybody's, at least one nail or close to it. But that's the one thing I've been messing around with, is the sizing in the shape kits. Kayla took sizing kits to school today because I offered. She's like, I'll pay for them. I told her, no, it's okay. If you want to go and give them to the people in the play to see if they want nails for their play, I will do those ones pro bono as, you know, a little give back to the school for the play kind of thing. And I'll, you know, who knows, maybe they might turn into a customer later. I said, it's okay, you don't have to pay for them. I will do that. If they want them, I will do it. Because who knows, some of those girls might want their prom nails. When you say mountain peaks, are you referring to sculpted? This is just what the company that I got them from called them, mountain peaks. So instead of the almond shape, they called them short mountain peaks. And I just like them because I will stab myself if they're a point. So as you can see, they come to a square tip. That's the only difference I find between these and the almond kind of ones, is they come to like a squared tip. So kind of like, you know, the top of a mountain. I guess that's why they came up with it. I just know that this is, I've never seen this one, this shape before, to be honest. It was always almonds. But because this company called it mountain peaks, I decided to try it out. And maybe it's because they kind of curve. You see, they kind of curve down. So like, you know, I don't know if you guys can see that, but like, so like for me, I can make a fist better with these ones because they kind of all have like a little curve in, which normally I'm against curve in nails, but these ones don't look that curved in when you're doing like something like this. But if you really look at them this way, you can kind of see they curve down a bit. I don't know why, but I just left the name of it as these were, because that way if I reorder them, I know what they are. Because, you know, to me, ballerinas and coffins are the exact same nail. I don't see much difference between them. They look the same to me. I'm so tempted to put something down, but they do long sets, which is way more forgiving. Yeah, long set. I'm not gonna lie. Like, I don't think I can go any longer. Like, these ones are quote unquote short. I don't know what planet these are short mountain peaks. I don't understand. These are medium squares. Okay, short mountain peaks kind of look like mediums to me. Well, actually, that's a size 6, so it would have been the next size, like, after this, because this was 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so this nail would kind of fit, like, there on the pattern, but, you know, they're pretty much the same size. So sometimes I don't understand where they get their numbers or nonsense from, I guess I call it. Sometimes I think maybe I should just get a 3D printer and try printing my own nails. Then I can make the sizes I want. Because, like, you know, there's some drag queens that have very, like, big nails, and I haven't been able to find a good one. So maybe I will get the Gel X. Well, I know I'll get the Gel X, because I know W2 Splinter wants nails. But it's whether or not I can find them sooner, or if I'm going to have to order them from the actual Gel X site and get them to come. Because every time I try to get them on Amazon, they're just sold out. But I will. I'll get them. I'm going to check a couple stores maybe this week to see if they have them in. Hopefully I can... Maybe Amanda's Beauty has them. That's like this... There's this one nail glue that all these TikTokers... I don't know if you guys have seen it yet. But all these TikTokers are like swearing by this nail glue. And like... You're getting 30 days out of it, hot showers and all this. Gel X has 000 now? Oh, that's what I need for my drag queen friends. Okay. That would definitely fit their thumbs. And they will love that. I'm gonna have to check it out. That's crazy and good and exciting all at the same time. Because, like, even my friend, I have one girlfriend that, like, she likes my press-on nails. She wants my press-on nails. But the sizes I have for thumbs right now, they don't cover her complete thumb. So, like, we've had to, you know, as I like to call it, jerry-rig the thumb. So we'll put it out a bit and then, like, maybe paint in black behind it. And mold it together kind of thing. But 00 thumb? Yeah, sign me up. I'm sold. I guess that's why Gel X is becoming one of the most popular brands among press-ons. Because they're actually listening to people. I'm thinking of ordering a solid nail glue. You can't use on pre-painted sets, but you can use a clear blanket. Ah, yeah. I think it was Sally... Is it Sally's? They have this big tube of, like, this big long, doesn't clog. Every TikToker's talking about it. It lasts 30 days. They shower with it. They swim with it. They do everything with their press-ons. And I'm like, really? Okay. I might be sold. I might be sold. But I'm always looking for bigger thumbs for the, you know, the thicker fingernails. I know my nails are short, fat, and stubby. Maybe it's because they're so short that I can get away with the zeros and the ones for my thumbs. I'm thinking of ordering I just love the fit of the Gel X. They're really huge nails and look the most natural of all of the tips I have. Nice. Yeah, I've been trying to get Gel X because I know, like, it's a popular brand among most people. Like I said, I've been struggling to get them because, me being a coffin user, mostly back then until I tried these Mountain Peaks, I don't want to get them in a size that I don't want to use, you know, like, to test out first. Because, like I said, I always like to test my products before I sell them to people. That's why, like, when I found these tabs, I was like, okay, we're switching. We're switching the main tabs. Because these tabs, I just did so much better than dealing with the frustration of the perforated ones. I want to add a little bit more down here. They are worth the money. The solid glue nail is in the pot, needs to be cured with a UV light. This one wasn't in a pot. It's like the people are using it for their like French tip, like cheap press-ons and stuff. So I'm pretty sure like there's no lamp needed for this glue. It's just a nail glue. But I have seen people using the potted gel to put nails on. I haven't been using any glue, just the tabs. But like I said, if you get hot, if you like hot showers, they will come off. That will happen. Oh, I didn't fix this one. Boxes used to have 10 sizes. Now they have 14 with half sizes and half sizes. I have not seen half sizes yet. I have not noticed half sizes. I've noticed the double zeros, but I never noticed the half zero or a triple zero. The triple zero is the first time I'm hearing this. And I'm definitely going to look into that because that sounds amazing to me. Because there's a few places around me that do like drag night. So it'd be cool to like, you know, go in there and be like, hey, where do you get your nails? They launched the almonds and everything and extra short also. Ooh, but it's extra short, because like some of the Amazon ones I've been getting that say extra short, they ended up being the same size as shorts. And I'm like, what? I'm not falling for this 100 times. But maybe that's also the difference between Canada and the US, what we're getting on Amazon. Hey, Punch Buggy, welcome in. I am working on we did a set like this. But not like this, actually. We did a darker set for a customer. And I really like this one. But I think I'm going to add more Christmas bulb kind of things to the tree. Because that's kind of what I want to do. I haven't decided if I'm getting Rudolph a nose. Or if I'm going to leave it white. But the customer, I gave her... I already took the other nail off. But I gave her the option of the lighter background and the darker background. She picked the darker background. But I like the lighter background. I like to see the trees, so I'm doing that set for myself now, but this set's for the customer. Which will hopefully get shipped this week. But welcome in, Punch Buggy. I hope you're having a fantastic Tuesday. Someone made an Excel sheet with the sizes and sent it to me. I can't find it. If I can find it, I'll send it to you. Oh, wow. I'm impressed. I'm liking these new sizes. They need to be helping us press on folks out. Because I know my friend would love the idea of the press-ons, but when I couldn't get her thumb to fit properly, you know, like when anything doesn't fit properly, it easier to fall off. And I told her, I'm always on the lookout for bigger thumbs. I kept telling her, I'm trying to get the Jellix. So, but to hear that they have other sizes, like they're going to triple zeros, I like it. See, most of the sets I've been getting, I don't know if it's the US versus Canada or something like that, but most of the sets I've been getting, I'm getting extra sets of fours and fives. And still 0 to 9. And I'm like, well, what happened to these double zeros and all this stuff? Like, am I falling behind? Okay. Now, I'm going to go in with, I think, that's the sparkle top coat. And, well, I guess I could use the sparkle top coat. Let's You can order each size separate too. Ooh. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna have to check out the actual Gel X website. I think it's because I saw that Paradise or Desert Paradise. They had some ones that looked like they were supposed to be short. But when I went to go do the shipping, it wanted to charge me $28 for shipping. And the nails were on sale at the time, so I think the nails were like $16-17. Painted Desert. Oh, that's what it's called. Okay. But the shipping was going to cost me more than the product itself. And I was like, I don't know if I'm willing to try that right now, being on a tight budget. I was like, it's saved on my list of ones to try out. But that shipping would kill me. Over time, that shipping is going to kill me. Okay, so I'm going with this sparkle again, but I wanted to add some more Christmas colors in there, I said. So let's, before I top coat these, because I like to stick the sparkles in the top coat. Yeah. There is a method to my madness, okay, people? I have those two. Gel X is much better. Okay, so if I'm going to waste my money on shipping, I should waste it on the Gel X. Noted, Sandy. Noted! It's just the shipping is what's deterred me right now. So, like, it's like if I can't get it off of Amazon, I kind of go, later. But I guess it'll be time to give in soon. So we're going to add a little bit of green to it this time. Because, you know, we want some of those Christmas colors. So I'm going to add some green. And I know I have red. You need to get your glitter. I need to get a room to do my nails in. I'm literally currently in the living room. I made a joke. I said to Kayla, I said, once you move out, your room's turning into a nail room. And Noah's like, no, it's going to be my extra room. I said, you don't need an extra room. Mommy now with starting this stuff. Mommy needs space. Mama's running out of everything. That's what I wanted. I wanted to add a little bit of the light blue. Glitter, right? I have a few. It's just all sitting in a basket. And we'll add a little bit of blue in there. So we got the green, red, and blue, kind of like the Christmas lights. Is there anything else? I don't want to over glitter it and lose the image. I think I'm sticking with just the big ones right now. Oh, but there's a darker blue. No, I'll keep it the lighter. Maybe. Let's see what this mix is like first. I know, I got to get more containers. I'm out of containers. All my containers are in use. Of course I have to make a mess, right? Glitter wouldn't be worth it if I didn't make a mess. Oh, thinking it's in like a container again. Okay, maybe I'll add a little of the dark blue. A little hint of dark blue would be fine. I just don't want the blue to be too overpowering. I think that'll be good. What do you guys think? Is that a good Christmas, or do you think I should add a little more red? I know it's so hard to show in this camera. Six. I think we'll be good. I think we'll be good. Nail room is my new exercise room. Well, the thing is, my exercise room was in the basement. My treadmill's still down there. But my basement gets so cold. That I don't know if I want, because when my daughter was doing her paper, that's where we used to roll papers. And I'm like, I don't know if I necessarily want to turn my basement into a nail room, because then the products get cold. I'm like, I don't know. What could we do? And I take a video conference call. Everybody asks what is over my shoulder. And then I turn the laptop. More cowbell. I like it. Micro gold. For sheer. Okay. I do have an extra bike. And if that counts. I have a treadmill. It's folded up. It's been folded up since March of last year. That's right. This year that just passed. You know what? Maybe because I'm doing a snowy nail, I'll add a little bit of white. It's kind of like a... We'll see. I just could have killed my sparkles, but we'll see. Add gold micro glitter. What, you think like this one? This is the gold one I have. Yeah, why not? A little bit of that too. Let's see. You know what? I think I'll stir it with one of my... That's definitely looking Christmassy. That's looking Christmassy. I think that'll work. I don't know, because I'm a red person, I kind of want to add a little more red, but no. Let it go. Let it go if you make more Christmas nails. We're just starting the Christmas season. Got my treadmill because I never used it. I was using my treadmill every day. 30 minutes, 2 or 3 times a day. But then my sugar started to drop at like 4, and I ended up like almost passing out on the treadmill. And I was like, I need to close up this treadmill and figure out what's going on with my body. And I meant to get back on it a couple times because my sister's been asking, when are you getting back on the treadmill so we can have treadmill chats? And I was like, when I fix the belt because it's over to one side, and I've just gotten lazy. Contrast with the background makes the glitter colors pop out more. Well, we're gonna see what it does. I'm gonna get my glitter brush. My glitter brush is full of glitter still, because you know that's just how this works. No matter how many times I clean this glitter brush, it just doesn't want to clean. Okay, so got my glitter brush. And if I remember correctly, I'm gonna. Oh yeah, I'm gonna do this one. Then I'll do the glitter one after. Unless the glitter is the herpes of craft world, right? Trust me. Ask my husband. I go to Michael's to get wool every once in a while when I'm making the kids' hats or whatever. If I can't find it at Walmart. And when I go to market, now that I've been doing nails, it's not just the wool section anymore. Now we have to go to the glitter section. I might need some glitters. I might need some new ones. That's where I got the beach charms. They had it for a resin. And I was like, ooh, I want to make beach ones. So I was like, this is good. Oh, trust me, never. No, never. It's the plague that keeps on giving, and I just put my nail stamper in it again. It's the plague that just keeps on giving. I forgot to dip that off to the side this time, so I put too much. It's okay, I can spread it out. That's the joy. Okay. Now, glitter is, trust me, I wake up some mornings, my husband wakes up and I'm like, you have glitter on you. He's like, where did I get glitter from? I don't know. I have no idea. It was not on my hands. Like, right now, I see them on my hands. And sometimes I'll be like, okay, I don't want to, if I know I'm doing a lot of glitter sets, like Christmas time, you know? I'm like, okay, I gotta wear gloves because I don't want to be, like, you know, getting different colored glitters and mixes of other people's. When it's my own, I don't care. I don't care. But, you know, depending on... My sets is like, I don't care how compoppled they are, because they're my sets. When I'm making others, I like to be a little more, like, you know, meticulous. Next time you're wine shopping, grab some chess tournament. Okay, that's the one I'll look into. Smaller than shimmering sand, even. I have a sand one. I do have a sand one. From when I did the beach. You know, I'm kind of curious. You know who I didn't see today? Has anybody seen J-Rob? I saw her yesterday, and she won the glitter. I was so impressed that she finally got her first young nail glitter, but I haven't seen her today. I wonder if she's doing okay. I don't think I've even seen her post on any Discords today. Hopefully she's just taking a nap. Or, you know, doing something fun with the hubby. Sometimes I'm curious if she's okay. Because I know that, you know, sometimes she gets a cold and it literally wipes her out. It's like power to just open a crack and embed in the skin, right? It does. It embeds anywhere, everywhere. I've actually gotten a piece of glitter once in my eyeball, and I was like, this is why you should wear safety glasses. This is why you should wear safety glasses when doing nail art. I kind of want a couple more in the center there. You forgot about your tea? Did you actually make it and forget it, or did you just forget to make it? because if not, that's some cold tea. That's some cold tea. I was thinking too, maybe I might do Tuesdays a little earlier, depending on, you know, how everyone was feeling. Because I know some people like the idea of going, because like, you know, Tuesdays there's no Young Nails. So I was like, maybe Tuesdays I'll do the start at 11:30 or 12 Eastern Standard Time. And kind of like fill that YN time slot on a Tuesday. Definitely, then it's more silenter because both kids are at school. Even though they're doing good today, they've not been too interested in hypering up mommy. I don't mind them trolling me. They're kids, you only live once, and I know that one day I'm gonna miss it. It's just the way it goes, right? The cycle of life. I made it and forgot it, but that's why God gave integrity to invent the microwave. Trust me, when our microwave gave out, I realized how much I actually use it. Because I didn't think I used it that much. I'm like, oh, we don't use it that much. Like, I don't cook in my microwave. Then I realized there's a lot of stuff that I do put in the microwave. Especially when it comes to reheating, because I'm too lazy to preheat that stove to reheat food. And I don't want to put it on a frying pan, you know, and heat it up that way. So I'm like, yep, nope. I don't care. Anyone that hates microwaves, I'm a microwave lover. Sorry. I know, because my mother-in-law is not a microwave lover. When she was living with us, she was like, preheat the oven to warm up the leftovers. And I was like, why? There's a microwave. She's like, oh, that's so bad for you. I'm like, I don't care. I'm using the microwave. I'm not spending time waiting for my oven to preheat, then putting it in the oven. No, I ain't got time for that. I want to eat. If I put it in the microwave, I can be eating in 5 minutes. My mom was like, she was so ready for all of her kids to move out. And now she's like, why don't you stay over here tonight? That'll be me. Trust me. I think Kayla will be the one that will be like, I'm going. And I'll be like, hey. Do you want to have a sleepover? We'll watch Christmas movies, especially around Christmas time. I'll watching movies with the kids, right? So I'm probably going to be like, it's Christmas. Tell your husband you're coming over for the night. We're going to watch Christmas movies. Because my husband's not one to care for those. I would not warm up the oven to heat up leftovers. Right? It just takes too much long. Like, I'll take my microwave. I don't care. I don't care. It gives me radiation or something. Whatever. You only live once, we get cancer from everything. Sorry to say it, but it's true. I'm looking forward to redoing my Mickey plaid for this year for myself too. So I think that one might be Thursdays. But I was thinking maybe one day this month or next month. Depending on how you guys feel about it, obviously. Maybe we'll do a paint a character together, like, you know, we'll pick a Christmas character, like a snowman or something, and we can all paint it if you want to. I'll show you how I paint mine. You show me what you ended up painting with yours. Kind of like a, almost like a paint along, but obviously, do it however you want. I'm not a professional by any means. But, you know, I just thought maybe that would be fun to do together, and then we all just posted in the Discord what we all came up with for the same character. You know, maybe somebody put a different hat. Maybe somebody put, you know? Just like letting the creative juices of Christmas flow. Or you might want to make a skull Christmas. Or Halloween Christmas. I thought maybe that would be a fun idea instead of you guys just sitting there watching me paint all the time. But obviously, if that's what you want, you guys can sit and watch me paint however long you want. Because this is my set, I'm kind of just playing with the sparkles a bit. I think I just cured my brush a bit. Oops. Where did you watch the X-Men series? Do you have a Hallmark calendar? I know, but I guarantee you my mother-in-law might have the Hallmark calendar. She's probably watching it on TV. I've just been watching it off of Tubi. The free with ads. I've been watching some on there. Because, well, I don't have my Netflix yet. Hopefully this week I'll have my Netflix back. So right now I only have Disney Plus. Unless that time's up for that one, I don't know. But I only have the Disney Plus and Paramount right now. So I'm kind of limited on where. Oh my goodness, I got so much. Look at this. I forgot to remember I told you guys I had a little extra here because I had to cut that nail down. Well, this is what happens if I didn't remove the sticky like I normally do right after I apply them. Now I got sparkle stuck on the inside, but that's only a little extra flare. But then I'm going to fix this because I don't want any dirt to attach in there. So I'll just rip out that part of the tab. Sometimes I'll cut it, but that one was too small to kind of cut because it just gets stuck in the nail clippers. And plus I didn't know where they were. But see, I just pluck it off like that and it's still stuck on solid. Large mystery box thingy that has been asked for is everything I've been asking for. Ooh, so it's gonna be like Christmas. So you're gonna hold yours till Christmas to open it, W? Huh? W? You're gonna open it on Christmas, right? Because you've been waiting so long for it. That's your Christmas gift? Skulls with Santa hat? That's cool. I like that idea. I like skulls. I do like Christmas. It's nice to know I have a place to go. If I'm ever in need, it won't be the first time without permanent residency. Thankfully, I've never had to live in a car. Thankfully, I have not had to live in a car. True story, though. Because, like I said, I'm always honest with you guys. I did pawn my engagement ring and every ring I own to come up with first and last. Because we got evicted from one of our places. Because, you know, we were on welfare and it didn't give us enough to cover the rent, so we got behind and we had to leave because I couldn't come up with the money fast enough. And, well, I found a place, but I needed to have first and last, and I didn't have first and last, so I pawned all my rings, all my jewelry. I pawned everything I had, but you know what? As much as, like, the sentimental of my engagement ring is gone, the point is my kids didn't have to go to a shelter. So, to me, it was worth the sacrifice. It was worth it for them. And I'd do it all over again. I would totally do it all over again. No questions asked. If it came between some kind of material thing or my children win. My pay rent at a place that I'm hardly at. That's true. That is true. If I'm not paying it, I wouldn't. Yeah. Why, thank you. But, you know, I think most of us would do anything for our children. I'm pretty sure you guys would do the same. If it came down to it, you'd be like, I can pawn material stuff and put a roof over my head. Well, the thing is, I did it at a when I pawned it, I was supposed to get it back, but by the time I came up with the money, it was too late. It was already gone, past the deadline. So, just I pawned it with the hopes of getting it back. It just didn't happen that way, which, meh, it's okay. My kids had a roof over their head, and that's all that mattered to me. Everything else, pointless. My kids are my life. I take him, my brother's kids, but not him or his wife. I couldn't afford to get incarcerated for murder. Yeah, that's what I always told my little sister to do. I'll take in the kids. You can have a box. That's the thing. If worst case came down to it, I knew I could move in with my parents. I knew I could move in with his parents. We both just didn't want that. We're like, no, we've been on our own since, well, my husband was 17 when he was on his own, 16 or 17, and I've been on my own since I was 19. I wasn't about to, you know, change that if I didn't have to. It's like, no, we pride ourselves on, you know, making ends meet and doing it on our own, that I was like, if we have no other choice, then obviously, instead of a shelter, I'm going to go live with people that, you know, but I don't want to. Because, you know, as much as you love family, there's some family that, you know, it's better when you only see them a few times a year. You know, the family is so much better in small dosage. This is why we send our kids to school. And this is why we love our grandkids even more. Because they can go home later. I couldn't afford to move out until I was in my late 20s. Recession was a killer. Oh, I believe it. But the funny thing is, when me and my husband first moved out, our one-bedroom apartment we started up was $750, I think it was. That same one-bedroom apartment today is like $1,200 or more. And I'm like, are you kidding me? I did Google it recently to kind of see, and I was like, are you kidding me? Like, we started there, same building, at $750. Then when we moved into our two-bedroom, that was at $950. And that one's now at, like, $2,000. And I was like, jeepers creepers. Because, like, these are not, like, nice places. Where we first started out, they weren't nice places. Like, as we like to say, like, me and the husband, when we joke about it, sometimes we're like, we lived in the ghetto. Yeah. We couldn't afford to live in nice places. We just lived where we could. Like, the amount of gunshots I heard. it was crazy. But thankfully, I was only in that location for 3 years. Then moved to another location that was a little better, but not much better because I was beside 3 bars. So there was a bar fight almost every night. To finally, 6 years ago, moving where I moved now, and I was like, me and my husband both said, we should have did this move a long time ago. I don't know why we hesitated, because should have did it a long time ago for the kids, because we're just so much more happier now. I didn't hit double-digit pay until my 5th job. And that was 5 years after I graduated. Oh, for sure. It everything takes time, right? Nothing's ever just, like, quick. Oh, that's because all the didn't shake it enough, I guess. That's why all the other one was at the bottom more. But meh, it's okay. I got kicked that out and figured it out. My first bedroom duplex cost me $450 a month. I could barely pay rent. And kids ate eggs and soup. Yeah, trust me, when we first moved out, we were on welfare. So I don't know what that's called in the States. But we were on welfare, and they were giving us only enough to cover our rent, so we'd have to go to food banks deep. But back then, the cool thing about back then, I don't know if you guys had the same thing, but back then, our hydro and water were included in our rent. So it was like, it was amazing, you know? It was like, okay, as long as I pay for the house, at least I have water in my house, and at least I have hydro, so woohoo. Just have to find food, and, well, we can't have anything nice, because, well, we're trying to find jobs. So it's like, you know, it's those learning curves that make you. That's why, like, sometimes, you know, you can tell. I don't want to say this because I don't want to, like, be mean or nothing, but you can tell a rich, spoiled brat when you see one. You know them when you know they've never lived the hard life. I guarantee you, I lived the hard life. And the funny thing is because, like, right now we're in a tough spot. It's like it's bringing back all those old memories. But then you just look back and you say, like, yeah, it might be tough today. But, you know, we made it out the last time. We'll make it out again. And thankfully, yes, I still haven't had to live in my car. But I did have to eat plant-based burgers last night, which... I made the plant-based burgers, and just in case the kids didn't like them, I made pasta. And I got some vegan cheese. Vegan Parmesan cheese. So last night was literally, like, besides the pasta, it was a vegan meal. And I was like, yeah, no, I can't do this vegan stuff. This is what I got from the food bank, so it wasn't because I chose to buy this stuff. But it was like, yeah, no, I can't do vegan, I'm sorry. I like my animal products a little too much. This is just... my palate cannot handle this. Now, maybe if I was forced to eat it for years, I might be able to handle it, but... mm-mm. Like I said, though, the plant-based burgers tasted a lot better than the back-in-the-day cardboards. Hello, H-Town. Welcome in. Hopefully you're having a fantastic Tuesday. You get lots of clients today, or was today your day off? I went from 9 hours to 14 hours. It's called welfare there too? Okay, thanks, Punch Buggy. Now I'm making 45. Well, that's good money, 45 an hour. That's good. But that's the thing, it takes progress, right? It takes hard work, dedication, and the worst thing is when you switch one job, you start right back at the bottom again and gotta, you know, claw your way up to the top. And that's like, right now, like, I feel like I'm treading water, you know, and I'm like, can I just start swimming? Like, I'm not asking to, like, jump out of the pool yet. But I'm at the point that I'm ready to start swimming again. Now, I'm just top-toting this again because I want it to be kind of like a more of a flat consistency before we go over with the stamping. So if you guys are like, but you just put top coat down. That's what I'm doing. And that's what hard work gets you. Right, Sandy? That's right. That's what hard work gets you. That's what 20 years contract work for me. Doubled my income for the last contract job and my first permanent job. Nice. Oh yeah, I've been there. They call it welfare too. I don't care. Yeah, they don't care. Like, one time when I was living on welfare too, my apartment cost $1,000. They gave me $999. So I was a dollar short for my rent. Like, you guys are supposed to help me keep the roof over my head, aren't you? Like, while my husband lost his job because he didn't qualify for EI because he wasn't there that long. But you're supposed to help me out, right? think that's why it frustrates when some people get lucky and seem to get all the help on it, and then you're trying to be like the honest one on it, and it's like, yeah, failing. I went to trade school, learned office skills, and went back to work. See, you killed it, Sandy. You're like, I'm doing the thing. I don't care. Lots of pancakes for dinner. We were a lot of rice, and well, hot dogs back then were like under a buck, so you'd buy a bag. We've been eating this again now. This is literally what we ate and we lived off while being poor. Okay, you go and buy your bag of rice because, you know, yes, rice is a little pricey, but that bag of rice is gonna last you the month, right? Roughly. Then you go buy a bunch of wieners, which now they're not so cheap because now you're paying almost $3 for wieners when back then you were paying like 50 cents for a pack. So you get all your wieners, and you chop them up with some onion, which, good job, J-Rob's not here actually because she doesn't like onion. So you chop up your onion, you saute your onions, and you chop your wieners up, saute them in oil. Add them to your rice, and there's your stir fry. I didn't say it was a pleasant one, but it was food. And that's what we had a lot of, I'm not gonna lie. Twice as long to get where I should have been in my 30s. Yeah, there's no set schedule, W2Learner. Because, like, I thought by now I'd be raking in sales for these press-ons. I'm like, okay, it's a year in, it'll start to like come in. Mind you, I'm at least now starting to get one sale a month, which, hey, it's slowly starting, but it's like I thought by now like I'd have two or three a week. But you know, it's a slow progress like anything else. You gotta work for it. So I'm not I'm not giving up. I'm still going. Early clients took the afternoon off because we have a client every day until Sunday. Whoa, busy, busy. You're gonna be rolling in the dough, honey. Good for you. I went to college at night to get my degree, and well, increased my income to my living wage. Nice. Yeah, that's the thing. If you want to make it, you gotta work your butt off. But the sad thing is, like, even now, like, this is why, like, I tell the kids, like, I'm not forcing my kids to go to college, okay? Because I honestly feel at this point in time, it's who you know that can get you into jobs more than what you know. Because I know people that have gone to university and come out and still can't get a job. But yet, someone that went to college for the same kind of thing might have got the job. Or even someone that just learned it off of YouTube with no credentials. So it's like, is it even worth paying all that money for college to come out and not do it? Like, and then I've had friends that have gone to like two or three different college degrees, and they're not doing what they went to school for, what they have degrees in. So it's like, I told the kids, I'm like, if you really want to do it, I'm not stopping you. I'm just saying there's just no point in like getting a student loan if you know, you're not 100% sure. I just feel it's not worth the money. But that could be my selfish way of thinking. We are all hardworking women here. That is right. We're all trying. We are trying to do what our fellow women fought for. You know, back in the day, women weren't allowed to work. Now us women, we're trying to like slay it. We are trying to slay. And the best thing about this group of people right here in my Twitch, hands down, is we're all about lifting each other up. Because I swear, when you walk into a grocery store or you walk around in public, these girls are not empowering each other. But yet this group of Twitch people right here, my nail peeps, you guys, oh, I love you guys. That's all I can say. Like, you guys, positive, shining light, helping each other out. Love it.
Something that I hate about the full-time parents doesn't count as an occupation for tuition.
Well, that's the thing. I think a stay-at-home parent should be getting some kind of pay, okay? I'm sorry. it's hard work to keep a household running. Get your kids, and like back in the day, yes, it was hard times for them too. Parent, like women, like they did a lot. But like nowadays, you gotta put your kids in social groups. You gotta put your kids in this program, that program. If you're not putting them in daycare, you know, oh, they need the social aspect. So now, or you got them in sports, so you have to transport them all around. Someone has to take time off of work to transport them all, or you're paying someone else's parents to drive your kids, and you're missing everything. So I totally get it. I pass on the onions. Well, Punch Buggy, I guess yours would be just wieners and rice. I used to live on beans with garlic, onion, and tomatoes on tostadas. Oh, that actually sounds pleasant. We did a lot of beans, rice, and cornbread. Beans, rice, and cornbread. That's not bad at all. I took my 12-year-old. Realized that had on. Yeah, the 2008 recession was bad. I'm not looking forward to where things are right now. Like, you know, like the price is going, like, there's so many kids going to go out without Christmas this year, which, yes, I get it. It's, you know, it's just a holiday of, like, as my husband always says, like, I always hate Christmas. It's just a, what's the word he uses? A gimmick to, just to see who buys what. Like, you shouldn't have to buy things for people and stuff like that. And I'm like, yeah, but it's the one time of the year, you know, where, like, maybe you really wanted something and your parents saved up to get it for you. It's that special moment. But there's a lot of kids that, you know, they're going to be lucky what they have under the tree this year. Yeah, the thing is, I worked at a daycare. And this is why I decided to be a stay-at-home mom. So I worked at a daycare, and they said that they would only give you 25% off, and that's only for one kid. So literally, I'd be paying the daycare what I was making. And I was like, so to put my kid in this daycare, I can't be in the same room with them because obviously they know that's not appropriate. But I'm literally working for you to pay it all back to you. I was like, no, I think I'll take the loss and just be a stay-at-home mom at that point. Like, you know, it's like, well, I think that's where you just made my decision. Thank you. Have a nice day. Looks like I'm being a stay-at-home mom. Sorry, I'm just looking for my stamper stuff and trying to catch up on the comments. Paint and polish, be right back. No worries. Some jobs require you to have a degree, no matter what it's in. That's true. Some jobs do. I thought that emote, right? I want it. Now I want pizza. It is, but kids, for kids, it's special. Yeah. I just, the only reason I say, like, you know, not every job needs a degree now, it's more of who you know, is because, like, you know, a tuition fees are going up too. Like, I'm all for it. You know, they want to go, they want to do it, but I just don't want to see them wasting, like, 7 or 8 years getting 2 or 3 degrees, you know, and then doing nothing with it. Like, I'd rather them to maybe take a gap year, decide on what you really wanted to do, search programs around that maybe you can get it cheaper done, or maybe there might be an apprenticeship program, or, you know, there are more options than paying for university. And sometimes it's good to weigh your options. Oh, this is the animal plate, so I'm gonna need that. There's my tree plate. And of course, I'm just looking for my swipe card, which I know what? I know I have another one, so I'll just take a new one out. Oh, those are my swatches. Ugh. How do you guys always get some form of rant out of me every stream? Alice's rant for the day is... Allison's opinion that nobody cares about is... Seems like you always get something out of me, don't you? But like I said, it's okay. You can all agree to disagree with me. I won't hate you. I promise. I promise. That was like I put on some Harold and Kumar thing the other day. And Nova came downstairs and I'm like, whoop, we need to change this channel. I was like, and he's like, Mom, what kind of scene are you watching? I was like, nothing. Go away. I'm not watching anything here. Oh my goodness, I couldn't find my swiper. I know Kayla was using it. But that's okay. I'll just take a new one out. I know I'll find it after the stream because that's always how it works. Always works the same way, right? Okay. Trees first. Four years. Necessity was a lie. If I'd gone into the workforce instead of college, I'd be at 50K less in the department and 10 years closer to retirement. Okay. Well, 50K less. Debt, that would be nice. Debt sucks. Right? Student loans are killer. And like, yes, you can save up money for college, but like every year that tuition goes up higher and higher. Like, there's only so much you can do. Like, I swear they make it impossible that you have to always have student loans, regardless. Like, unless there's some kind of miracle that I don't know about. We're all stuck paying those dreaded student loans. And then the worst thing is they want you to start paying that back, like, right away. And it's like, dude, I'm in school. I'm working a job just to keep paying my student loan. I'm not even, like, forget rent. You're living at home with your parents still. Like, these poor kids, man. They got it bad. And not even to mention how much more, like, you know, the loan goes up if you decide to live on campus because, you know, the drive's too far away. I feel for these kids. I do. Just forget them. The government can give billions of dollars to other countries. They can throw some at us, right? They can throw some at some of this food cost too right now and all this other nonsense. Like, yeah. I agree. I don't disagree with that. Like, that's the one thing that like, don't get me wrong. I don't mind the fact that, like, you know, we help people from war-torn countries come here to live. But when our rent right now is out to lunch and Canadians are, you know, yes, not all Canadians are 100% Canadian, but they've been here long, passed down through their families and stuff, right? So they're Canadian. And we cannot, they're living in tents, but we have money to bring more people in. Shouldn't we take care of the situation we have at hand first and then, you know? I know, it's just my opinion. Ooh, that actually turned out pretty, guys. Okay, let's continue the process, right? Trust the process. That's what we all say, right? Trust the process. I get that, but not exactly fair for people that paid direct without a loan. At least we're paying for education, like...
they didn't. That is true, direct with that alone. But, you know, that's again, it, like, with the statement of, like, you know, rich people paying more taxes and stuff. Same kind of, you know, thing going on there. I'm almost out of acetone. Well, what happened there? Guess Kayla was using up all my acetone. It's okay. Hopefully, as long as I have enough to do this, that's all that matters. I have one ball in here that's probably soaked. I can't believe it. I'm out of acetone. Always gotta be something, right? It's okay. It's okay. Just breathe. Well, who paid as they went had families that paid for them. Not everyone has those opportunities. That is true. There are some people that, you know, their parents didn't have to struggle, so maybe they put all their baby bonus. I don't know what you guys call it, but the baby bonus away. Into their college funds. There were some programs that were, like, told about to us when we were younger to do for the kids, but I didn't like the fact of paying in this money, but if your kid doesn't go to college, you don't get it back. I was like, how do I know I'm gonna raise, you know, non-delinquent children? I'm really gonna risk putting thousands of dollars into something that if they don't go to college, I don't get back? That's dumb. I'd rather have kept that in my bank account for a rainy day. Kind of deal, you know? Yeah, I'm going to put this on a pinky because I didn't like this pickup as much, but I do like these branches here, so I think the short one would be better. Perfect. Hello, J-Rob. Welcome in. I asked you, I hope you're feeling good today, because I noticed that I hadn't seen you much in any of the things that I was on today, and I was like, I hope she's not feeling bad. So welcome in. Hopefully you're having a fantastic Tuesday. I'd be okay forgiving interest if necessary, but I agree to pay, even if it was a rocket. I also when I pay for anyone else. I totally get that. Or a two-income household that didn't depend on the loan money to live. Yeah, for us, we were a one-house income. Well, there's been times where I've had daycare and we've been two-house income, but I've been always the nice person that would be like, I'd watch your kids for $5 an hour. And because I was too nice and I, you know, single mom would come at me and I'd be like, yeah, no problem. Being the nice guy, you know, you don't make a lot of money being the nice guy. I was just sick of being taken advantage of and I decided maybe daycare is not for me because I have too big of a heart. And then, you know, I couldn't pay this month. It's okay. Half the price this month, you know? So I was like, no, this is not the business for me. That's why, like, even me putting the prices on my nails that I put on them, I keep questioning if they're too high. I'm like, maybe these are too high. Why are they not selling? Is it too high? Ugh, I hate. I'm the worst person. I self-sabotage myself all the time. I couldn't afford the cash flow thing. It's Jira. Hey, Jira. Were your ears burning? Right? What's the reason? There's life insurance that gave college money. If you're not needed, then you can take it out. My uncle worked in that, and we were going to get the life insurance for both my husband and I next week. Nice. I've had a few life insurances, but the problem is once you can't make a payment, a couple of payments, say like, because you're lost your job and I'm looking for jobs, you lose everything you put in. I've had like 6 or 7 life insurances now, and lost everything I put in. So I want to get it again, but I was like I'd rather just have one that, you know. I almost want to put it just in a savings account for the kids. here's the access to it when, you know, when need be, like in a will. I don't know. I just don't like playing with money anymore. I've lived through too many hard times. Oh, my dogs woke me up to potty. Oh, they wanted to get the school bus? Right? I know, you finally won. I was so excited. Art is the thought. Arket. I like your winter animal set, but it was too short and I don't know if it will. I don't know if they'll fit me. Oh, no worries. I'm going to try and get the Gel X now that, like, I know they have bigger thumb size. I'm going to go maybe even take a 45-minute drive into the city and see what nail stores I can hit. But I'm going to find those Gel X. Not going to be sold out. But I will try to get coffins because that's what I normally like, unless there's a request for a different shape. But I'll start off with coffins and see if I can get those. Oh wait, I think you said coffin and almonds are your favorite. So if I can't find coffins, I'll see if I can find almonds. Come on. Come on. I've had this cotton ball stuck in here this whole time. And it absorbed what's left, I think. I'm just gonna tuck it in here again. Oh. Yeah, making a mess. That's what I do best. Yeah, that one was soaked with acetone. That's where all my acetone is hiding. I've never worn press-ons. I like medium and short natural coffins. Okay, medium and short natural coffins. I will look for those. Coffin work better for my day-to-day job. I type a lot. So you prefer a medium to short coffin. Okay. Could always send you some to paint for me. Well, I guess if you sent them, I'd obviously be giving you a huge discount because you have to mail them here first. But I will try and see if I can get them first because I know I wanted to use, like, to get that brand. So I'll see. If not, if you really want the set, we'll message on the Discord. We tested it. You can take a picture of your nails at the coin. Oh no, she knows her sizes for Gel X, but she has 00s for nails, and I don't have any 00 nails. That's the problem. I've been looking for bigger thumbs because, like I said, one of my girlfriends, she needs bigger thumbs, and I haven't. Every time I try to get the Gel X off of Amazon, because I was always looking for coffins, they'd always be sold. Or, like, I wouldn't get paid, and then when I get paid, I'd look, and they'd be sold out again. So I know they're very popular. So I've always wanted to, like, you know, try them.
We might have to end up finishing this set tomorrow, guys. I'm gonna try my best. I know, like, we're going a little over, but I can only go till this last, oh, you guys did not see that. I just dropped my thing in there. Trying to keep it from drying out. Might have to finish this set tomorrow, on Thursday, at this rate. I keep going backwards instead of ahead. So I missed everything. Did anyone get the mystery boxes? I have not gotten any mystery boxes because, well, the husband was supposed to get paid yesterday, and we didn't because we forgot that Monday was a holiday. So now, after I pay the bills, I have to see what's left. Because for me, even the small box, I'm going to have to pay, I think, $25 out of pocket just to get the small box with my two gift cards. So, I'm just doing the mask. The mask. Okay, I know I had the second one. Where did I put that now? Oh, there it is. Okay. I got two L's and the one M and the S one. Two larges. Ooh. I'm excited to unpack the things I've been asking for forever. I got another box just because my sister wants the portable one. Yeah, that portable one is nice, I'm not gonna lie. Okay. Mine isn't portable, mine has to plug in. As you saw me using today. See, this is how much acetone is left. That's why I'm using this sponge. But now I got my thing stuck in here. Ugh. Note to self, don't do dumb stuff. Dumb ways to die. Okay. Maybe I'll try these. You know, it's like I said, handy dandy tweezers are handy dandy for everything. I'll just cut the bottle if I have to. Aha! I'm a genius! I'm gonna put it here from now on. There you go. Okay. No, the weight of it's too heavy. Hold, there you go. Okay. Okay. I'm thinking of getting a set for myself. Nails. Seems like she could. She has the art supplies for years. You know, that's a great Christmas gift for your sister. Then maybe you won't have to get anything for your sister for Christmas. The boxes are the gift. The boxes are the gift that keeps on giving. Right? That's what they say, right? The boxes are the gift that keeps on giving. I got Little Lars specifically for the extra thingy that I've been asking for. I think it's kind of hard to do paper nails with a plug, and dogs don't exactly sit on the table. Yeah, that's for sure. I hate being connected to my computer or some, well, with streaming, I'm using my light connection because I only have one jack on my light. So my phone's plugged in there, so, you know, I don't lose video. Because you all know how that's happened a couple times because I forgot to plug it in. So I have to plug it into my computer if I'm making a video. And it's like, I totally get the cordless one. And at first I was going to think about becoming the mobile nail tech. But A, I don't drive. And, well, I wasn't going to bombard my husband. Which he agreed he'd do it on weekends. But I was like, that's just crippling my ability. So that's why I thought to go the press-on route. But like I said, if I have to go back to doing gel nails and practice at doing acrylics, because I'm not the best at acrylics, well, if the press-ons don't work out, there's still options in the same industry. That's the one cool thing about nails. I actually want to make these into a set of earrings, too. Because I like that a lot. I'm debating a nap or shower. I'm oily. I hate when I get oily hair. When I get oily hair, my scalp gets itchy, and that's usually what annoys me the most. And I'm like, nope. I'll say, I'll take a shower before bed, but because it's wintertime now and it's like colder, I like taking my showers during the day now. So I'm like, while kids are at school, I'll take my shower. Before I used to not care, but I don't like to be have wet hair in the early mornings. So, and I definitely don't like going to bed with wet hair because, well, then I look like I got punched with a scarecrow. Like me and a scarecrow got in a fight that night. I think that's what I'll be doing after YN tomorrow, is getting my shower during after YN. But man, was I the only one like that felt like Monday was taking forever to stream? I'm like, dude, they released the mystery boxes and like, why did they like, I swear it was 11, like I went to my doctor's appointment thinking, oh, okay, I'm going to be late and it's going to start. I got home, I had food. And I was like, it's 11:40 something. Like, where are they? I was like, maybe they just aren't doing a stream today. I'm like, I checked Discord and it didn't say no stream, right? So I was like, what's going on? I was like, did they forget about us today? You know, we just found out what was in the box. I'm just going to try and get these trees on, and then Thursday, we'll put the animals on because I'm literally running out of acetone to finish the set. I was going to stay a little later and finish the set today, but clearly can only go so much. I like the fact that doing nails is relatively later resistant. Doing nails. The one thing I like about doing nails is, especially for me, for like doing the press-on business, is like the nail art for me. You can't have my pickle. I still haven't tried the pickle pizza yet, but that's still on my bucket list. That one's still on my bucket list. Ugh, now I'm stuck. Now I forgot what I was saying because the pickle distracted me. No, it's okay though. Oh, the press-ons. It's the fact that, like, as you see, some sets take me, like, hours. Like, when I did the gel overlay on my nails, the Hezuka on my thumb took me 8 hours alone just for the one character. So, like, I like the fact that I can build the set on the press-ons and put them on and, you know. I don't know if I could sit still at a salon that long for that set, even though if I was doing it myself, I know it might not take as long. Somebody else that was like higher speed and great art could do it, then it'd be a little different. keep dropping it. What? I'm only going to do these two nails because I have to wait to finish the set later because I'm out of acetone. So I'll get that tomorrow so we can finish the setup at the beginning of Thursday's stream. And then we'll get into a second set. Maybe then we'll do the ugly sweaters. I know we still have to do ugly sweaters this season. Tis the season to ugly sweater. La 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 la. No, I said I'm not gonna sing. I quit. But that's the thing. Like, that's the one thing that drives me nuts about some people liking press-ons. Though they're like, oh, I just want basic press-ons. Well, go to the salon and get your basic nails. The reason I like press-ons is you don't have to sit in my chair for 5 hours and you can have epic art. The people on stream saying they don't want to know. Why are you here then? Exactly, paint and polish. That's what I was saying with the young nails. Like, don't tell me. Well, stay off the streams. Things are going to slip up. And you definitely don't want to read the chat because, you know, just like telling everybody, do not enter the raffle. Let Tracy win. How many people listen to that? So you think people are really going to keep off the chat what's in the boxes? No, they're going to be chatting it up. If you really want your box to be a mystery, you disconnect your internet for the next couple weeks until you're supposed to get your shipment. Because for me, it'd be 2 weeks, roughly, depending on when the notice of delivery comes in. So it could be even longer than that, depending on how many orders they had, right? I could be waiting a month for my order. Because of being international. Okay. Well, this is where, as far as we're going to get today for doing these nails, we'll have to finish the, because I need white next, and this sponge that the little bit of acetone I have on it is all covered in black. So, this is where we're forced to end today, unfortunately. But it's all good, you know? It happens. I've been craving fried pickles. Now you got me wanting fried pickles. My husband the other day was like, do you want pickle pizza? I was like, no, because, you know, I know my son hates pickles. So I was like, nah, it's okay. We'll get it some other time. I think I just acetone the crap out of my desk, so it might be white from now on. Oops. Right, you gotta know it with 400 people. They're going to be talking about the boxes, right? Especially when you have excitement over it. Like, oh my goodness, did you see this is in the box? Are you excited? I'm excited to see those brushes, though. So you guys are going to have to let me know because I definitely won't be getting the large box. But you need to tell me about those brushes. Are they? I need to know if they're like the kind of the, like my favorite one here. Because if not, I'm rebuying this one, but... You know, I want thin ones like this. Mind you, I got stamping all over my fingers. I'm a messy person, but... You see, I want thin ones like this. I need more like this. I like them. I need to get some better, thicker ones, too, for filling in, like, block work and stuff. But, you know, it happens. You can always hit mute. That is true. You could. It's too hard to. When they're asking when... The lamps will be in, right? That one especially, like, that, as soon as J-Rob told me, she's like, hey, I ordered, but guess what? I think I might be right because the lights are out of stock. I'm like, how are the lights out of stock? I was like, J-Rob's right then. They are in the box. Like, why else would they be out of stock on a major sale? That's like number one thing that you want to sell. Those and the dust collectors, you know?
It takes 2 weeks for me to get my YN packages.
So, yeah, it takes you 2 weeks to get your YN package, then, yeah. Pickles on cheeseburger pizza, yum. Mmm. I've never had that. That does sound yum.
I felt pretty excited finding out I've been right about the cure lamp in the box.
Trust me, as soon as you told me that, sent me the picture and said that it's out of stock, I think I'm right. I was like, okay, now you have even more proof to say that you're right.
And then when I saw the Greg unboxing, I was like, oh, see, J-Rob knows. I'm just going to ask her next year what's in the box.
What's in the box, J-Rob?
I bought last night the art brushes they came out with. Wasn't impressed. Nails by Dev's brushes are really the best.
I've seen her brushes. I watched her TikTok, the follow along of the penguin that she did. That was fun. That's why I kind of thought the idea of, like, maybe you guys might want to paint it. Like, we pick a character together on Discord. Like, just say, like, a character. Send the picture out. And we all kind of, like, try our hand at it and see what we all come up with. No competition, but, you know, just see what each person comes up with. Maybe someone does a green hat, a blue hat, you know? I think it'd be fun and cute.
And then we'd have a collection of, like, you know.
A crazy art, I guess you'd say.
Well, because I do have a little bit of white here, I'll add a couple little colors of dobs to see if we get a tea leaf reading. Because obviously we only used white today. So they give us a little tea leaf reading. Oh, I just messed that up. Great. I am the worst at making my nail polishes all gloppy all over the top. I'm going to have to spend a day just to clean out the tops of these. I know I just saw someone. Oh, that was you. Like, I know I just saw someone in the corner of my eye. Okay. And why not throw some black down? Okay. I think we got a nice little bit of colors. I haven't tried hers yet. They're really good too. I've washed her watercolor.
Is that the same one you were telling me about for the acrylic paintbrush lady? I'm bad with people's names, guys. You guys have to help me out. I'm so horrible. I feel like I'm such a bad person because I keep messing up people's names.
ING screen record. Put it on the IG live. I screen record it and put it on YouTube. Okay. I haven't tried hers yet. I kind of want to try Tivo's brushes.
Well, that's the thing. I wanted to try some of Tivo's products, but I've heard so many people say that they're not that great, and I was like, well, then I don't know if I want to waste this money on them. But at the same time, it's like, you know, personal preference. Okay, this is what we got today, guys. Yet again, I see a chicken out of the. I see two colorful chickens. I don't know. I like chickens, I guess. Well, let me try to put it more centered for you.
Because for one stroke, yeah, the angled brush for cheaper, but they are full but compacted.
Okay, I see a dinosaur head. I can see that.
A cactus and a flower. Oh, cactus and a flower. Green looks like a coffee cup
with lava coffee.
I see butterfly.
Butterfly. We get a lot of butterflies, don't we?
We get a lot of butterflies.
I like that I've been putting them in Discord and seeing you guys draw what you're seeing. Mind you, I'm struggling to draw with my fingers on there. I'm like, kids, can I have the tablet so I can actually draw what I want to see precisely?
Be have a field day. Rose. Guess we'll flip it now. Let's see what we get. Roachess would have a field day. Ask for Ramon tomorrow. Again, lol. Now, I see, like, this is Yoshi mixed with Mini. Yoshi versus, like, half Yoshi, half Minnie Mouse. Roller skate. But I like some of you guys that have been putting in the drawings on them, which I think is so cool. But I do see the roller skates too. He's developed the ink blot test, and since DMV has been determined to be useless and incognito for any diagnostic. Oh, trust me, sometimes I look at those ink blot tests. That's what that is. Okay, that explains it then. Thank you. I was a little like, Roger. I'm like, I'm even pronouncing it wrong. Okay, now I get what you're saying, W. But yeah, trust me. I'm like, when they show them in movies and they're like butterfly, I'm like, it literally looks like someone just threw paint. There is no image there. Rorschach. Okay, thank you. Yes, I see roller skates, J-Rob. Right? I had the purple roller skate. And maybe a green one. I see that too. I guess we'll switch it. I'm pretty sure this is the way we haven't done it. Now this looks more like roller skates. Oh, this also looks like a car or a boat. Like, you know, what is that? The cartoon that the kids watch with cars that have eyes? I see like two little eyes. I forget what that's called. Where's a kid when you need one? They know it all. Cars. Of course, because that would be so simple, right? Duck. It's one of my favorite ones. I sing the song for that one all the time. Especially to the kids. They get annoyed. I can't remember the words right now because I'm drawing a blank. But you know the road traveled on? One day here, the next day gone. Yeah. McQueen. Yes, Lightning McQueen. Exactly. Mater is one of the characters. Mater is one of my favorite. You know, without the two. That's not Pinchetto ice cream, right? That's not Pinchetto. Wasabi. Mind you, wasabi ice cream is actually good. I know. It's weird. I love wasabi, but I hate spice. Explain that. Oh, now I really see a butterfly this way. Whoa. The butterfly came back again. You don't like wasabi, J-Rob? Wasabi is delightful. I love the wasabi. I see. That, yeah, I can see that too. Wasabi peas are good. I don't think I've ever had wasabi peas. Now that's something interesting. We've gone all four ways, right? I'm trying to remember, but I'm pretty sure we started here. Yeah, cause the cup. Okay. I've decided nap. Well, that's always a good way to go. Well, we're going to be finishing this setup tomorrow. Not tomorrow. Thursday. I'm still thinking about maybe Tuesdays. We might switch the time to earlier. I don't know. Debating. I'm going through stuff. Trying to decide. Should we take up the YN time slot on Tuesdays? And then keep the later streams the other day? Or should we just stick to our regular streams? I want to do what's best for everybody, you know? But it was kind of fun to pick a little earlier time slot and change it up a little bit, you know? But, you know, do a poll. That is true. A poll would be good, wouldn't it? Then we'd know for sure what you guys would like. But it would only be for on Tuesdays. Obviously, Thursdays, because why in streams? It's okay, I can get the pole going. I just have to see my bar, because my light is blocking it. But maybe we've reached different people doing two different time slots during the week. But obviously Thursdays and Fridays, we keep it to the same time as usual. Or at least that's my thought. Let me see if I can pull up the poll before we end. Just give me a second. That's my one free noontime. That is your one free noontime. But we'll see what you guys say. Maybe we'll put the poll on a couple times this week and decide for next week. Tuesday stream, 11:30 EST, or the same time, 3 PM EST. And we'll run it for, I guess, 3 minutes. Start poll. Oh, gosh, I'm dropping plates on the floor, guys. Now I think I'm going to roll over a dog, so I have to look behind me. Ugh. But the poll should be up, right, guys? The poll's up. You guys tell me what you want. Maybe we'll ask this on Thursday and Friday. Majority rules. We're gonna also zoom down. Cause I thought I've been moving the thing, but look at this. I forgot I could do this. Ugh. Well, look at my hands. Ew, don't look at my cracked old hands. Ugh, ugh, wrinkly, disgusting hands. I guess I'm comical. So this is what we got done. We'll add the animals. I might add some even more like snowy look to the branches. Possibly. I was trying to zoom in, but I think I'm just gonna bring it down. Bring it down. Yeah, I think that works. I'm trying to get, I'm so like off, like trying to center this and like put lights on it. That's, I don't know, I feel that's better. I gotta get a better light eventually. It's okay, we're getting there. Oh, I can't, my PC is off, no worries. Oh, trust me. Lately, I've been not sleeping at all, spending all night just lying in my bed, staring at the flipping ceiling. And then as soon as I'm tired, it's time to get up and take the kids to school. And I'm just like, why? Why do you just hate me? I'm hoping. That's one of my free noon times. I didn't sleep last night, so I had a migraine. Oh, because like yesterday I didn't have Pepsi because my husband didn't get paid yesterday like I thought I was. So the day without Pepsi, oh yeah. By the time I was trying to, last night my head was pounding off me. I was like, oh my gosh, I'm going to die. I'm okay with either going to be an option. Oh, I should have thought of either. Sorry, Sandy. I guess we'll do that one on Thursdays. We'll add that one to Thursday's prediction either. I'm just going to get a rough idea. We'll ask it a couple times and see where people kind of fall. Ryan is on every other day at noon.
Does it really have something every other day at noon? I guess because I'm not always following them on the TikTok or Instagram, because sometimes I can watch those videos later. Both times work for me, mostly. They publish Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Discord most Fridays. Yeah. Fridays, usually the Discord's around 12, I find, my time. I could also overstamp with white. That is true. We could overstamp with some white. But I think I might add some sparkly sparkly. But we're putting the white deer, so I don't want to... I gotta do the white deer first and see what we're gonna do with those after that. But I do like them. Obviously, they'll come together better once we top coat them too. But I ran out of acetone, so I couldn't do them. Okay, I guess Tuesday stream, it looked like I didn't get to see all the votes, but I think I have it left up here. Here we go. View results. Come on. So we had 2 votes for 11:30 and 0 for 3. Okay, so far we're thinking more of Tuesday at 11:30. Okay. The thing is, too, if I do it at 11:30, I probably could run a little longer stream. Because I can still end in time to cook the kids' supper. Like right now, like at 6:30, I gotta end because I gotta feed the kids. But, you know, if we do it earlier, I might be able to extend streams for you guys. And, like, we can get more in-depth into some sets. But, you know what? What do you guys think? I want another question. I won't do it as a poll. We'll do it a poll later. But so far... Do you like the other colors added, or do you think the more simplistic colors? I like this because I'm a Christmas freak, but I guess we can compare them when we finish it, but, you know? Don't think the colors took away from it. We might still add some branches onto it to fill in the branches, but I'm going to put the animal on first before we do that. But that's... They are fun. I'm not going to lie. We are working on them. I like both. Okay. Yeah, I am too. It's been raining for 2 straight days, making my head hurt. Oh, that is not good. Well, hopefully you'll feel better soon. I don't know why I just can't sleep at night. Well, that's a lie. I do know why. Because first I had the heat on. Then I had the AC on. Then I had the heat on again. And last night it was so hot I couldn't sleep. And I wanted to come down and put on the AC, but I'm like, everyone else will be cold. I'm like, oh my goodness, this is driving me nuts. Pressure change, cluster migraines. Well, I guess we'll end it here today, guys, because I have to feed the childrens. But I want to thank you guys for hanging out and chatting with me today and keeping me company. You guys are my therapy, all the therapy I need. I enjoy every moment with you guys. I want you guys to remember to have a positive evening. Remember to always stay positive. And we will see you on Thursday at 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And we'll be finishing up this set and then continuing on maybe sweater nails. I know that's something we've been juggling around with doing. But I just, after doing that for the client, I've just been like, I want these nails. So I have to be a little greedy. But we'll see you tomorrow in YN. And I'm going to put it out there again. Somebody from this chat that was on this stream today, lurking, watching or something, they are going to win the giveaway, the raffle. Someone here, putting it out there again. Bye, guys. Have a fantastic evening.